homemade pretzels at the crib, bro. You know you're a full-blown family man. you over here twisting pretzels like.
And bro, yeah. and then, not only that though, but when you start popping the popcorn in the pot.
Oh yeah.
Full blown.
Bro, it don't full taste no family. Different, bro. Why we act like that's so exclusive, like.
Bro. Nah, it is, bro. Because I did it, bro.
Give me the bag, bro.
Hey, how old were y'all? How old were y'all when y'all realized that the little hole in the popcorn bag is to shake the extra kernels out?
What you talking about, bro?
Today.
What you mean, bro?
Today.
You know what you mean, my boy?
The little slot. You know how the popcorn bag, like it don't completely close all the way. You're supposed to shake whenever you pop the popcorn. You know, it's always unpopped ones. You're supposed to shake it, and them joints fall out, bro.
What you mean, my boy?
Yeah, what's going on right now, bro?
Hey, bro.
He telling Liz right now, like, yo, did you know
that? Hey, babe.
I keep telling y'all, man. Y'all boys got to get on TikTok, man. Y'all got to get on TikTok, bro. I be learning everything from TikTok.
Well, I got to get, bro, you on TikTok. on TikTok, we on
Caleb
TikTok.
Caleb got us, man. He got us, man.
But that's the type, it's but it's funny, though. Like, that's the type of stuff that comes up on my feed on TikTok. Like, stuff like that. Like, that's my For You page.
Recipe.
All right, man. We already live. Let me at least hit the intro, bro. We over here.
One time for the two.
What's good, everybody? Welcome to the Honest to God podcast, episode 87. Hey. Who we got for 87, Mouth?
There's no Mouth.
No 87s, bro. I'm not going to lie to y'all.
Lil Grunk, then. We going Grunk.
Bro, that mug is still going, bro.
We going low, bro. Not big grunt.
All right, man. Enough of the applause. God dang. We going Lil Grunk for 87?
Lil Grunk, yeah.
Hey, man. We what was I about to say? This cat Malk distracting me with the text. It's like, nah. We almost to 100, bro. We almost there, bro.
Yeah,
like,
we get there, bro.
We right there, bro.
We gonna get there, bro.
We so close. So close.
Yeah, hey, man, you know that we get there close. For a year out. We gonna get there for the year out for sure.
We gonna be our 13 pods this year,
bro.
That's all it takes, bro. That's all.
Yeah,
it
we
needs.
Don't get there before the year's out. That's a horrible year for us, bro.
It was terrible, bro.
That's a horrible year for us if we can't get there for that.
We definitely the Anthony Davis of podcast if we don't get
there. Yeah, that's facts, bro. Because we inconsistent with pod, but when we do, it's, you know, we come through. Like AD, he's showing up. James, he plays. He's showing so.
Yeah, you choppy again, bro. We might have to come back.
It's Mike, man. It's my mic. I don't know why. I'm not doing nothing differently, man. It's weird. Y'all go ahead. Y'all keep going, man. Get the libs out and all that. I'm gonna get this mic.
Yeah, who got the libs last week? Carter, right?
Yeah.
I got the libs.
Carter with the libs. No, boop.
Yeah, you gotta get him out first, bro. You can't.
Oh, yeah.
Get him some joints out. Y'all guys is doing it. Ain't nobody hit him yet.
I don't know, bro. What was we on last week?
Hold on. We were talking about the, music. We talked about the little cop situation. We talked about, that was the main two things we kind of talked about.
Yeah, that was the main stuff, yeah.
We talked a little sports.
I don't know, bro. I don't know if I should even give them away. I feel like I should just keep them.
Hey, man, you feel like it's time to keep them?
You going to keep them?
I feel like I got to keep them this week.
Man, congrats, bro. I gotta find my mic, man. Hold on.
Give it to him. Congrats, bro.
Congrats, bro.
First of all, I want to thank me.
That's silly. Kittle, your congrats, bro.
Hey, I literally have a card from Caleb from my graduation party. And that's all it say.
What
it say? It just say congrats, bro. From Kayla. That's all it say.
Bro, okay, that sounds similar. That sounds like Kayla. That
sounds like Kayla. Why do you still have that?
Hey, wait. I got it here.
Wait.
Dennis, get him, Dennis.
Listen, bro. I'm like 13 years out now. Like, hold on, Malt. No, we on 15.
Yeah, we like 15. Bro.
Y'all graduated the same year.
Yeah.
Hey, Carter, that's wild. Man.
Hold on, man.
Have a graduation card. Have a graduation card. How are you? Caleb going crazy right now. Hey, but bro, having graduation cards in 2023 and we graduated between 2008 and 2010 is nuts, bro.
I ain't got it, bro. I ain't even got it. It ain't in my house.
Yes, you do, bro. You said that Jamal crib. It's a Jamal crib.
Bro, I can't control what she keeping, what she giving.
Hey, bro, I got so much old stuff that my mom, listen, my mom and them got so much stuff, bro. They just threw it away this year.
From 08,
bro.
Yeah.
The backdrop I had that I had people sign for my graduation.
Oh, they just threw it out?
Bro, they just threw it out like a few months ago, bro. Dude. Like, there's nothing I can do with that. And they tried to give me all this stuff. Like, my mom brought me, when my mom moved out here, and they packed up everything, bro. They had a box of stuff for me. Stuff that I haven't seen since, like, literally 2009, 2010.
They're like, here, honey, take it.
And they really brought it to me, man. You know what I'm saying? Only thing I kept out of that is our 08 prom pick. Me and the homies, the 08 prom pick.
Yeah, that's
where everything goes, I just, when they brought it into the crib, I took it right to the dumpster.
Bro, you can't do it right in front of him, bro.
Hey, bro, it was shoes and everything, bro.
You gotta wait at least till they leave, bro. Books.
I mean, no, like, I don't know why they was holding on to this stuff, though. Like, that ain't my problem. Bro, I can't do nothing with
different,
it.
Here, right? We different than that generation, bro. I feel like our moms and dads' generation, I feel like they keep everything, like, because it's so sentimental. Bro, I be throwing away sentimental stuff, bro. I'd be throwing it straight to the trash.
Bro, I get a card and throw it away the next week.
Right, me too.
Here's your report card from kindergarten.
Like, what? Why you still sound choppy right now.
Yeah, choppy.
I don't know why my mic is tripping, bro. I just have to go with the computer mic if it's horrible.
Hey man. StreamYard don't want us to be great.
Does it sound bad right here?
No, you just sound loud.
All right,
loud.
I'm going to just go with that. I'm going to be loud, up, but.
It's better, bro.
You see, I'm like against the wall, bro. I can't go back no further.
What's up,
bro? I still sound loud.
You sound loud as ever, bro.
That's crazy, bro.
You good.
But I was gonna ask y'all, what do you do with cards, bro? Like, what, like, bro, cards is kind of a dumb thing, bro. Like, why do we give cards for occasion? Like, and then you know what's going right in the trash? Because what do you expect people to do with that?
Inside of the card, they want what's in the card. The rest is thrown.
That's it.
Right? Because I do. I'm not gonna lie. Cat, give me a card, bro. I'm gonna read it. Oh, that's a nice card. That's the last I ever read that card.
They lucky if I even read that joint, bro. I'm gonna be honest with you.
Yo, what's up, bro?
I just go like this. Like, I open it up.
Bro, we got married, me and my wife read every card. But like by the time it got to like the middle of the pile, bro, it's like, all right, 50 good. 20 cool. 100 cool. thank you.
Yeah, it's too many.
Thank you.
Right.
Y'all don't got warm and fuzzy folders?
Nah, I don't even know what that is, bro.
You just get like one file folder where you keep all of your like gifts, something like that, so that you can have it for like a rainy day if you feel sad or whatever. Just like something like this, bro. Something like this. Just
so you got
whatever cards.
That's his right there. That's Carlin's right there. He just pulled it up.
Nah, I got one at work for like stuff that kids write me. I just put it in there.
Oh yeah, because Carlin, you need it for that, bro.
I need it for that.
You know, you need it. If you have
like birthdays and all that,
Let me ask you, Malk and
text me the card.
Cash at me. Send me a nice text.
Malk and Carlin, let me ask y'all this. Y'all know we at the age now where, well, Malk been at that age, but the kids start bringing stuff home from school, a little artwork and stuff. How much of that stuff do you keep, bro?
All of it.
I do too, but eventually it's like, bro. No, I do. I ain't gonna lie, I didn't, because like when he's like two, like, you know, the teachers is just doing it for him. Like, they like, oh, look what he made. Like, he ain't make that, right? Like, you just did it. But now it's like, I definitely keep it. But it's like, how long? Like, come on, man. He's three. He bringing some home every day. Like, how long?
Bro, you gotta take, you gotta take your favorite, bro.
That's what I'm thinking, bro. That's what I'm thinking.
That's what I was thinking. Take the best one. Take his best work and post it on the fridge.
Bro, yeah, this is what I think you should do, bro. And this is what I think. You know, get everything, and then every month, just evaluate and look and see what's trash. Throw it out. See what's good. You can save for the graduation party. Put it to the side. Process of elimination.
That's bro, but he's three. Right, like, none of it is that great. Like, he's three, bro. Ain't nothing gonna be like, oh, wow, this is really good. Like,
hey, look, anything he bring home and he can explain to you what it is, that's what you keep.
Right. Oh, I gotta throw everything out then.
It is Caleb.
It is fun though, like having a kid bring stuff home. They'd be like, look what I made at school.
See, but Jason's smart though. He might come and say, Daddy, I drew an esophagus.
Yeah, Jay's is smart like that. Yeah, bro.
Like, what is this? This is actually the master right here, Dad.
Yeah.
I drew my phalanges.
No. Jason would come home and say something random like that too. He'd be like, bro, what? Where did you learn that?
Yeah. Jay's smart as a mug, bro. You can tell Nadia you're prepping him to be the doctor. He's gonna be a doctor when he get older.
I don't know, bro.
He already got anatomy vocabulary, bro. That anatomy, bro. I flunked the first semester, bro. Anatomy was the hardest.
Yeah, anatomy is
had to be the hardest subject I ever had, bro.
Yeah, anatomy is tough.
But Jason's gonna be ready, bro. He's gonna be
ready. Yeah, we'll see. Shoot, man. What we gotta get to today, man? We got Dummy of the Day award to give away, the new segment. I ain't even think through it, bro. Got honesty awards. I got an honesty award. Let's get to honesty awards.
Okay.
Let's get to it. You special. You be rapping. You everywhere. You out here in the mud, man. Respect that.
Keep winning.
I want to give an honesty award, man. So today we had a outreach in the community where we gave away coats, hats, and gloves that people donated to us to give to kids in the community, man. It'd be kids out here at the bus stops in the cold with no coats, bro. No hats or nothing. Like, just so we like, man, we gotta definitely do something to meet that need. So today we gave away like over 100 coats, hats, and gloves to the kids in the neighborhood, man. So I just want to give an honesty award to everybody who donated and everybody who came out, man.
Amen.
Everybody who came out,
give
man.
Give them a round
of applause,
man.
Got to. I'm not gonna lie, bro. It's so cold here, bro. I went outside with just a hoodie and
You set yourself up, bro.
I let the dog out with the hoodie and the pajama pants, bro, and came in ready to cry, bro. It was like 2 degrees last night.
Oh, my gosh.
It was freezing, bro.
Yeah, this morning was like 7. I'm like, yo, what happened? Bro, I was walking around outside. I had icicles in my little tiny icicles in my mustache and my beard. That's how cold it was, bro. I'm out here like, man.
They're supposed to get to like the 50s, though, and they're talking about the groundhog to the 6 weeks left, man.
Listen, you ever see how they word that with the groundhog?
Give me the 50s, bro.
What you mean?
Like, they say, if the groundhog, whether, I don't even know, they'll say,
if you see a shadow?
Yeah, 6 more weeks of winter, and then they'll say, 6 weeks until spring. They're the same thing, right?
Yeah, it's the same thing.
Like, it just worded.
Bro, listen, every year, listen, bro, if you want spring to be 6 weeks away, six more weeks, just say that. We it's don't need grandpa. We don't need the groundhog, bro.
Bro, don't it seem like Groundhog Day was early this year, though? And how like, do you know what the it's only the beginning of February, bro. Like, winter is still here. We already know it ain't going over yet.
How do you know the groundhog ain't blind, bro?
Right. Right, bro. Like, what if the sun ain't even out that day? Like, that's the whole point. Like, yeah, that don't make no sense, bro. Hey, man, get that groundhog out of here.
And plus, the original groundhog homie died.
He probably dead. Yeah, he dead.
We got something. Been dead, bro.
Punxsutawney Phil is gone. Now we got Punxsutawney Jim. And we're going off what he said. But it's going to be 50 next week, though.
Bro, we done been through like 7 groundhogs, probably, bro. It ain't like.
More than that, bro.
Oh, yeah, bro, at least.
Groundhog Day used to be a big day. I never even knew. I didn't even know when Groundhog Day was the shit. Like, I just looked on the news. They said the groundhog seen the shadow or he didn't see the shadow 6 more weeks.
Bro, I swear it's extra holidays.
Nobody even warned me that this was coming.
I swear it's more holidays now than it was when we was kids, bro. Like,
oh, definitely.
Kids be off of school. They'd be like, what day is it? They'd be like, it's Frederick Erickson Day or something. Like, bro, what? Yeah, like, man, we ain't never get that day off of school. Like,
Thomas Edison Day, bro. We get the whole week off. Like, what?
Bro,
like,
and now they get off school for anything, bro.
Anything,
bro. Like, anything I remember hoping and praying that the 8 inches was going to get us off, bro.
Right, bro.
Now they get 3. It's over with.
Bro, they got the idea of, it's supposed to snow tomorrow. We shutting everything down.
Yeah, in Ohio. Like, bro, we know how it goes in Ohio. You wait till the morning. You never get your hopes up until the morning.
Right.
Unless it's real bad. Only when it was real bad, they cancel it at night.
Then you knew, like, yeah.
You don't get your hopes up until morning because it could be a blizzard and they got the streets clear by 7 a.m.
Streets be clear. They be out there 4 a.m. on the road.
Bryce be so disappointed, bro. I wake up first thing in the morning, look out the window like, yo, my street ain't even white. Like, you can see the whole road.
Mad as one.
Right, and if you know you're on a side street and it's clear, know the main road.
The main road is super clear.
If you want a side street in Youngstown and it's clear, you having school.
You
got
that's a fact.
You having school.
Wake up.
Yeah. And it sucked being in the Youngstown, like the Youngstown schools, because you got to wait until the very end of the thing coming through the TV.
You don't even know you ain't got school for 20 minutes. Everybody else don't got school.
East Palestine. You wait. Beaver Local.
Beaver Local is always first.
Beaver Local, first
they
one.
Close first,
they close instantly. As soon as it starts snowing, Beaver Local out. All right, East Liverpool, done.
And then you start getting older and you understand the game. So you're like, all right, if these schools close, we definitely close.
Yeah.
But if I don't see these schools, we went school.
The first Youngstown City school I see, I know we close. Like, it don't matter which one it is. It could be like Boney, anything. I'm like, yep, we close.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, man. I swear, it's crazy though. The kids was off for voting this year. Like, they had off of school for the voting.
Voting was a fun day at school. Like, right. Like, voting was like the lightest day at school. Remember, I don't know if y'all used to have these though, but when I was younger and I was. Mo, did you go to Harding?
No.
You didn't go to Harding? No, all right, so when we was younger, we used to have these days where you just go outside, you playing games all day.
Yeah,
like,
we
nothing.
Did that, yeah.
That's what voting days was like, bro. Now it's like, school, another day off.
Right. Like, for what, though? Yeah,
right. Nice. It ain't like they could vote, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Anybody else got honesty awards, man?
Yeah, bro. All right, you gotta give a honesty award to Derek Carr.
Oh,
man. for his comments at the Pro Bowl stuff.
I didn't even know what he said.
Bro, he got a high score with the QB challenge, and they're like, man, this is the loosest you've been and the best performance you've had back since you've been back in the facility. He's like, yep, and that's why I ain't gonna be here next year. Just like straight like that, like honest, like just on camera.
Dang,
like,
bro.
Yep, I did good because there's no pressure, and I ain't gonna be here no more.
I'm gonna have to see that. That's kind of wild, bro. Yeah, shout out to him. He out, bro. He gone. Man, we definitely gotta. Oh, go ahead.
Oh, you probably was going there, man. Honestly, yeah. Award for the GOAT, man. The GOAT.
Again, bro. The again. GOAT. The GOAT this is the second time we've done this, bro. This is the second time we've done this, man. Thomas Bradyson. Yeah, go get your family back, bro. What are we talking about, man? Yeah, forget football.
Bro, you shouldn't even be in this predicament, bro.
You should have retired.
That's facts.
We congratulated you last year at this time.
At this time, bro. same time, probably. It was like around the same time same last
week,
year, bro.
It was the same week.
It was literally like the same week. And like, yeah, Brady retired. Then we came back next week. Like, nope, he ain't retired. Brady, hey, listen, yeah. He had a great career, man. You know, it's time to hang it up, bro. Go get your family back.
He had the best career of all time when it comes to football, man. Nothing else to prove, man. You just need to prove that you can get your wife back now.
Yeah, I mean,
Giselle is Giselle, bro. Like, I don't know why you wouldn't want to.
Yeah, bro.
I don't even know what else to say.
Never go Eric Burnett.
Bro, that has to be. I got to get that sound clip so we can use that as a drop, bro. That's too much. I don't know what else to say.
So he might take us down.
Yeah, man, they definitely going to get us. Every time we play Andre, they get us. And every time we play
Ho. We don't do nothing but big you up, Ho. All we need is a few words, bro.
Yeah, that's man, just let me use that, bro.
Dennis, I thought you were going to say, oh, we need a feature. That's what I thought you were going to say.
Oh, we need I would love feature. To get a whole Eric, podcast, though.
Hov don't pop out for nobody.
Imagine how lit that would be. Well, who y'all got in the bowl, though, man?
Yeah, I want to hear y'all predictions, because after last week, I told you, man.
I mean, the refs, as long as the refs keep it right.
Hey, bro.
I don't know who to pick.
Don't even do that.
I can't even.
Listen, Mahomes is anything, like, if he's anything better than he was last week, I'm not betting against him. I'm not betting on that game, period. If Mahomes is at least 80-90%. I'm not betting on that game at all, bro. He's phenomenal.
Man. I don't think did I say Mahomes is gonna lose last week? I don't remember saying that.
I said it was gonna depend, bro.
Y'all said if Mahomes was healthy, if he was 100%, then maybe. But y'all all said Bengals, bro. Y'all all said Bengals.
Man, Mahomes is different, bro. I would never like.
Yeah.
Mahomes is different, bro. That dude is like.
He cemented it, bro.
Bro, he's like. He's one of the best I've seen play. Like, obviously, Brady is the GOAT, but, like, watching this dude play, bro, he does stuff that I ain't never seen before. Like, that dude is like. I don't know.
Yeah, like, bro, he's different. He's the best football player with handles ever, bro.
He out there with grip, like, crossing cats up on the football field, though, with a hurt ankle. Like, nah, but he, like, for real, this dude, just some of the throws, bro. Like, he throwing on a foot. He can't even put pressure on his right foot like that, and he throwing dots, like. Straight.
Bro, that pass
bullets,
to MBS
like,
was crazy.
Crazy,
dude,
bro.
Dude, this far away from the ball, he just.
Bro, right just
touchdown.
Like. And he could, like, he don't.
Throw.
The thing about Mahomes is, like, he could throw it any type of way. Like, yeah, he could bro. Throw it's a sidearm pass yeah, right on baseball. Point. He could yeah. underarm that. He could throw it underarm like that, bro. Like, he's so accurate. Like, he could squeeze it in the little tight spaces, like.
Something
he might,
bro. Mahomes,
so, KC, everybody?
Something else about Mahomes, bro, is that last, like, bro, nothing can stop him, bro. Like, nobody, he didn't run the whole game until it counted, bro. Like, and he was out of there, too. Like, he was out of there, though. Like, he was not going to be denied that first down, bro. I just think, man, you know.
If it's a team that says to beat him, it's Philly, though.
What do you say?
They're the best team in the league.
That could beat them. Like, they're built
Philly's
to
the
beat
best
them.
Team in the league. Definitely.
All around team,
Mahomes,
yeah. But
they got the best blitz. Quarterback during the league.
Because they got Darius Slay. Like, Philly ain't. It ain't going to be.
Nah, Philly ain't. Yeah,
crazy.
Philly ain't
D-Ron
sorry.
Crazy.
At all. Yeah. Philly all around is a tough, tough squad.
But Mahomes is like. LeBron. Like,
yeah, Jalen Hurts ain't Mahomes. That's the thing. Like,
you could be a better team, but like Mahomes, his play can elevate, like make it equal. You know what
and
I'm
then,
saying?
Bro, all he need is Travis Kelce. If he got Travis Kelce, nothing else matters, bro.
Right.
Like, he can have Valdez Scantling. He can have Juju. But as long as he got Kelce, they in the game. Like,
these cats is all hurt, though, too. That's the only thing that I'm worried about with Kansas City is because they all hurt, bro. Juju is hurt. Like, these cats, they mad injured. Yeah. But as long as Mahomes is good to go.
I'm not touching that
They always. I'm not either. I'm not touching it. You gotta do the free joint though. You gotta do the free bingo joint. They got.
That's it. I ain't gonna touch that game, man. I'm gonna just put the Mahomes gonna get 200 plus. That's it.
That's all. Yeah.
I bet on who winning, who losing, nothing.
The underrated part of that game was the special team, because with a chance to like get back into the game, Kansas City, instead of going for it on third and fourth down, punted the ball and got it within the 10 and the 14. It's hard to drive the ball 85, 90 yards. And the Bengals couldn't get past the 50.
Yeah.
And they forced them to punt the ball and get the ball back.
Your Chiefs defense is on one last week.
Y'all think Burrow a little too cocky for where he's at?
I like it, bro.
I like it too. I like it brings different spice to the game.
Yeah, bro. But he was talking like they was talking mad trash, bro.
Well, they disrespect this.
Calling it Burrowhead and stuff. Yeah. Like, that was. I feel like that was dumb.
But he
dumb.
Beat him.
Disrespectful.
To be
bro.
Honest, though, he was 3-0 against Mahomes. So I get why they were saying that, though.
Yeah, but this is. Gotta
go by facts. Yeah, but like.
All them dubs ain't an Arrowhead, though. That's disrespectful, bro.
That's disrespectful.
I like it, Joe Burrow.
They won by three. They did. They not blowing them out. Like, if I'm blowing you out, that's like Rodgers saying he owns the Bears because they blow them out. The Bengals wasn't blow. They was winning by field goal. Every time, by three.
I think his confidence is what makes him really good, though. Like, his confidence is a part of why he's good. I just think stuff like that, like, and that wasn't necessarily him. It was other cats.
The antics makes the game, bro.
Especially this new generation.
No, it's never worked, but it just make it fun to watch, though. Like, yeah, now you got – he called him the Burrowhead. Everybody in Kansas City is. Tight,
that's why.
Bro.
That's why I was dumb though. You putting an extra battery in their back like that. They really wanted to kill this dude. Like,
they don't do that.
But it was like
sacked four times in the first quarter.
Yeah, yeah, bro. Especially when your O line ain't really all that. Like,
and then Chris Jones get his first few sacks of the
Chris
playoffs
Jones
ever.
Getting busy.
Not ever. Getting busy on bro.
He's getting busy, busy.
It reminded me
of
when
I saw him do a move that was crazy when they tackled
Chris Jones.
He just. Threw him. He was getting held. Threw the guy. Got him off of him. It's like, that's tough, bro. Yeah. That's that guy's livelihood to stop him from sacking the quarterback. And he's making it look easy.
Yeah, Kansas City a better team than last year. A better all-around team. Like, they can actually run. That's going to be the key. Because Pacheco can actually, like, take the ball out of Mahomes'
Where
hands.
Where is Clyde Edwards-Helaire, bro?
Nah, bro. He been done for like the seventh week in the season.
He got hurt or nah, he just sat down? Just, they sat him down.
Yeah.
Yeah, sat. They was competing in practice and
got him up out of
it. Wasn't doing it.
So they went with Pacheco and McKinnon. I only know this because of fantasy, bro. Pacheco was on the waiver wire. I just picked him up, rode him to the championship.
McKinnon is like. He's that
like
receiver.
McKinnon.
He's that extra receiver out of the backfield.
Yeah, I like McKinnon. He adds something different to the game. Like, Jared McKinnon, y'all,
like
I mean, the Kansas City not having him, it to me, like, changes the game plan.
Yeah,
like, you can double
it's like
Kelce
when
with McKinnon coming out
Pollard.
The backfield.
It's like when Dallas lost Tony Pollard, they lost everything.
Yeah.
They lost everything with that. You know what I'm saying?
Even doubling Kelce, like, Kelce's still going to get busy. You know what I'm saying? Like,
they ain't going to stop Kelce.
It's gonna be a good game. Yeah. I don't know who to pick. I'm gonna just.
Hey, real quick though, man.
Good game.
Hey, real quick, man. I hate to see it. I ain't want to see the Niners go out like that, bro.
Yeah, it wasn't fair.
Not like that.
That wasn't fair from the start, bro.
Like,
cats getting injured left
first
and right.
Series, your Glock Purdy out. He didn't catch the gut out there. Yeah. And y'all put in homie, and they had a list of teams that he played for. He played for
14
like
different teams. Yeah,
he played for like the San Diego Vipers or something. Something weird.
What is that, bro?
You know what I'm saying?
XFL.
What is that, bro?
And that came from the XFL.
Like Canadian League or something. Bro. I don't know. And then they got Christian McCaffrey out there warming up, taking some
time. Right.
Like, Jalen Hurts don't have to put on no clinic. They made this easy. This
they put McCaffrey at quarterback. It's a slow day,
then
bro.
Then as I left the room, I'm coming back. Little Mal like, McCaffrey playing court. I'm like, what are you talking about? That don't make any sense, bro.
Yeah, bro, that game was over from the start.
That's the only thing I was thinking about, bro. That Eagles offense is going to get tested next week. I mean, their defense is going.
Yeah, they ain't have no test against San Francisco. Like, they couldn't throw the ball. They couldn't pass. After the first quarter, they didn't even try to pass. They like, nah, we just going to hand the ball off. We're going to do, put McCaffrey in the Wildcat or whatever. Like, hey, that touchdown by McCaffrey was one of the toughest runs I've seen in a long time, though, bro. Like, that dude is different, bro. I ain't never seen a white dude get busy like that.
Hey, George Patton, you a dummy, bro. We could have had him. You stupid, just let you know.
Dang.
My bad. I get mad.
Hey, bro, y'all trading draft picks for head coaches, bro.
Hey, we need that. Sean Payton, what's up, man?
I ain't never seen that in my life.
I saw that, Monk, and I realized one thing about that, Monk. I still got Russell Wilson.
And he gonna get right. He gonna get right.
Sure.
This is all we need to do. We need him to not turn the ball over. Like, if you listen,
bro. They said if we score 18 points a game, bro. But we're not talking about Drew Brees, bro.
No, we don't need don't turn up. That defense was good enough to be in the Super Bowl. Just score 18 points a game. We would have been like 9-1 or something like that. They were saying.
Hey, bro.
That's all we need.
You're probably right.
Hey, bro, Russ is over for us. Bro,
listen, he might be, but that defense, I'm telling y'all. Patrick Surtain, best corner in the league.
Y'all got to score touchdowns, though.
That's what I'm saying. If we could get 21 points next year.
And then but that's,
bro, 21 is a long haul. Touchdowns.
That's a long haul when y'all going.
But we
when
need
y'all,
Judy healthy and Javonte Williams. Like, a lot of our players did get hurt, so.
And y'all still gonna do all of that and get smoked by Kansas City.
Hey, and we might and we might not.
Y'all division too tough, though. Y'all gotta beef up everywhere. Like, cause y'all division is tough.
Defense. Not that defense was good, bro.
Y'all defense is solid, but y'all losing games 12-9, though. Y'all losing games 12-9.
If Jerry Jeudy stay healthy, or 6-9. So you get, like, we ain't had no number one receiver. We had like Tim Patrick got hurt too. So it's just Courtland Sutton out there. So.
Oh yeah, Courtland Sutton being number one, it ain't much you gonna do with Russ.
Yeah, and then Russ was his.
Russell Wilson, Russell Westbrook, all these RW dudes.
Yo,
bro,
Rachel, she been hating Russell.
It's over with. He said Russell Westbrook. All the Russells, get up out of here.
All the RWs, get them out of here.
Get all the Russells out of here. Man, we might as well.
Westbrook, six man.
I'm about to say we might as well stick with basketball, man.
Yeah. Hey,
Kyrie. Hey, all that stuff y'all been talking about the Lakers, man. All that stuff and all the negativity I've had about the Lakers, bro. I take it back if we get Kyrie. I take it all back, bro.
They're taking it back.
I take it all back, bro.
Why now?
We just gotta wait to see, man.
I mean, like, why Kyrie do this right now? I got my theories.
I mean, I when Dennis sent it to the chat, I'm like, oh, that's why.
I think he been done.
So my thoughts was, all right, KD injury is bigger than what they making it seem. KD might be out for the season, but ain't nobody saying that. Or it might last long enough to where they'll be out of playoff contention.
Yeah.
And you know,
he don't got no faith in it. Yeah,
faith in that because he's getting 40 a game and they losing.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Or
let's go, Russ.
Y'all said something, though. Y'all said that the way that they handle his situation with the anti-Semitic, this him getting his get back.
He ain't get over that.
If there's one player in the NBA who's going to do that, it's Kyrie. He the most petty player ever.
Bro, what timing would hurt them the worst? Like, what timing would hurt the worst right before the trade deadline? Like, you know what? Get me out of here, man. Yeah.
So that's what I think. I think Kyrie just waited. I'm going to do what y'all going to do.
Like, the Nets got to go down as one of the worst organizations ever if they just had all these players in the palm of their hands, and everybody just like, yeah. First, they had a terrible playoff. They got swept the first round last year of the playoffs. Bro, they got the most disappointing superstar squad I've ever seen, bro. You can't have KD, Kyrie, and... I've been telling y'all that, bro. I've been telling y'all that because y'all was talking about, man, come to L.A. Like, heck no, bro. Get Ben Simmons out of here.
I think he would have been good in L.A., bro.
No, bro. We don't need stop.
Him to score. No.
We don't need him to score. Listen, we need a facilitator. That's all we need. Then,
bro, I don't want no LeBron point guard James, that can't shoot the ball.
No,
bro.
But look, though, having bro, we LeBron got James one, there, LeBron James, though, is the difference, bro. LeBron
Ben James Simmons. Is different. Ben Simmons would be completely useless, bro. Like, he would be useless to us, bro.
We just need another ball handler for him, man. That's it.
LeBron killed.
We need Kyrie. That's the ball handler we need. Kyrie. He could create his own shots. He could shoot.
His whole career, Brown always got the ball, and people just watch him. If he got somebody who can, like, create the offense.
Yeah, well, he got that with AD. When AD is healthy, he got that with him. That's why we so good. But with Kyrie, too, bro, like, him and, like, bro, think about him and Kyrie in Cleveland together. Like, he low-key gave Kyrie a little bit of freedom to do what he did. Like, that's why they were so good. Like,
hey, look at LeGM, by the way. LeGM, listen, you know he gonna be gone in a couple years anyway. So how can I help LA? Let me get AD under contract and, you know, hopefully Kyrie. Then I can be on up out of here, man.
Yeah, man. I don't even care about the antics with Kyrie, bro. I just, man, just come, bro.
Yo, yeah.
You can say whatever you want.
I'm in a win now mentality, bro.
You can post whatever documentary you want to post. Hey, bro, just come to LA.
Listen, Kyrie.
You got free reign, bro. Kyrie. You can tweet what you want to tweet.
Kobe, yo, man, come get a ring for Kobe, Kyrie.
Kyrie, bro. Kyrie to the Lakers.
It makes sense, man.
Hey, and Kyrie ain't been doing nothing but singing Braun praises, though, all season.
Oh, bro. Yeah. He wants all to play season. With them, bro. You already know they want that to happen.
All season. Bro. He done matured a little bit. He know greatness. He ain't seen a dub since Braun.
Right.
Only dub is with Braun. Like,
so this is a question. What y'all willing to give up for Kyrie?
Anything but Braun.
Whatever
80,
we need to.
Bro,
or something.
That's what I said. Bro. That's what I said. Anything. Westbrook, get out. Schroeder, Beverly. Hamachura or whatever. Dude, we just got homeboy. Get him out.
Coaches,
yeah. Darvin Ham.
You can get rid of Jeannie Buss.
Jeannie Buss, all of them, bro.
Take Rob Pelinka, take everything.
Especially Rob. Rob should be first.
That should be the number one thing in the
number one draft pick.
Hey, y'all getting Rob Pelinka right now.
Trading the owner for a player is silly, bro. Yeah, yeah, yeah. How you gonna trade the owner? You're like,
trade Jimmy Westwood. Yeah.
Hey, Phil Jackson, stay away, bro. Because every time they say Jeannie Buss go ask Phil Jackson, and then like the trade don't happen. So Phil Jackson, stay away.
They still talk. Oh, they were like,
nah, I think they together,
Magic.
Bro.
Listen, go ask what? Magic what he
ain't
thinks.
Jeannie Buss and Phil Jackson together?
Not no they more. That was like, nah, they been broke up, bro. No, they not, bro.
Bro, look it up.
Then they just got back together, bro. I just watched the whole documentary on these cats. They was divorced.
Nah, they weren't never married.
I thought they was just together.
They were like, just together, bro.
They broke up, I thought.
They was on that Kanye and Kim
and 2.0. New Bay.
They still together? That's crazy if they are.
Yeah, man. Phil Jackson ain't going nowhere, bro. Phil Jackson, Laker for life.
Oh, no, they did break up. They broke up.
You're right.
They were engaged prior to their breakup. Yeah, bro, they've been broke up, man.
Yeah, so don't even ask Clown Boy. Just stay away.
No. We want Phil Jackson, bro. We want Phil Jackson.
No, trade him, too, actually.
What we going to do with Phil Jackson, bro?
Anything, bro. Phil Jackson is a winner. What are y'all talking about, bro? Phil Jackson brought us ships.
Bro, this is a different NBA, bro.
Nah, I don't care, bro. He knows how to handle superstars like that.
He can't do nothing with the Knicks, though, bro. Nah. Now, Phil post-Laker career is trash.
Yeah, you're right.
Just come to L.A., man.
Unless he coaching. If we had him as a coach, I'll take him. But, not an owner or a GM. Yeah, that's true.
Past coaching the chips is over with.
Yeah, come on. Come on, Kyrie. Come on home.
Yeah, man, I think it's slow in Brooklyn all over again.
Yeah.
KD ain't saying nothing, I don't think.
Bro, if we get Kyrie, we instantly contenders, bro. Yeah, we instantly contenders.
Bro, that means AD could get hurt tonight. No, and we still got another 30 points on the board, though. Now, that's what I'm saying. Like, no. Listen, last game KD played, AD played, bro, he got up slow.
That's a bad sign.
And I thought about that, bro. And I thought about that. I said, man, with Kyrie, that's 30 a game without AD.
Still, yeah.
We need that.
And he on the floor. Kyrie is kind of durable now. Like his last
bro, but season, think about all three of them together, though, when they all are healthy. God.
That's gonna help.
That might be one of the scariest teams. Like,
bro, listen.
Because, you know, Kyrie throwing lobs at AD all day.
LeBron was already scary with Kyrie. Dog, you talking about Kevin Love on steroids.
Steroids. Mega you know steroids. What I'm
saying? Like, Bron ain't never had Kyrie with AD.
Mega steroids.
Like, he had Kyrie with Kevin Love. He got the job then, but, man, are you talking that's about all world?
Make it happen. Make it happen. That's it, man.
Make it happen, bro. That's it. Shoot, we got the sports early today. We got off on sports, man. What do y'all want to talk about, bro?
Yeah, this is my weekly reminder to John Jones. Don't do no recreational drugs.
Yeah, stay off the coke. Stay off the weed.
March 4th
stay
is
off
coming
the,
soon enough, bro. Just
Shrooms, fight, all that. Just stay away.
Do whatever you want to do after, bro.
When is the fight?
March 4th, bro.
Yeah, I'm putting money on John Jones.
That's a long way away,
man. We got 30 days. We got like a month. Yeah, we got a month. That's what I'm saying, man.
I ain't putting it on him yet. I ain't putting him on it yet. But day before, maybe, I'm going to put some money on John Jones.
Yeah, you got to make sure he clear way in.
Yeah, I ain't doing it early.
You got to make sure he at the arena for the fight.
Yeah, we'll see him in the ring. Like,
hey, how did that work though, bro? Because John Jones normally get caught after the fight, though. Right?
No, sometimes he get caught before too. Like he
okay,
was,
okay.
But like Dana don't care, so because like he makes so much money, so it's just kind of like whatever.
Hey, what happened? What like Dana White got caught on video smacking his wife, and nothing ever happened, bro.
He making too many people too much money, bro. Ain't nothing happening.
What you laughing for, bro?
Damn, bro, like,
and nothing happened. Like, bro, in today's age,
terrible,
how does that happen, bro?
Yeah,
like,
that's terrible, bro.
Bro, he's on camera. Like,
you talking about
smacking her.
I mean, but you talking about a cat that's over a whole sport, bro. You know they gonna make sure that don't stick.
Yeah, they the way TMZ even reported it, like you know, normally somebody was like, Ray Rice punched, like, they ain't do none of that. Like, Dana White is sorry for what happened to, like, we ain't even know that happened. So, like,
come right out, like, yeah, I should have never did it. Like, yeah, but you did smack her, though. But, man, that's kind of wild.
Yeah.
I was about to say something right before you said that.
My bad.
I forget. No, that's cool.
You know, I just got to do it weekly, let this cat know. I'm not saying, like, he listens.
Man, it's a slow news week, man. What guess I got a random question for y'all. I got a random one.
Hey, what's up?
We ain't did one of them lists in a while. You know, the list 1 through 5.
Yeah.
What you got? So, all right. I'm gonna name these five things. I want y'all to put them in order 1 through 5, all right? We got Bob Evans, Perkins.
Like what we saying, breakfast?
Waffle House, Cracker Barrel, and Denny's.
What we saying? Breakfast? What we saying?
I'll go first, bro. Waffle House, number one. Bob Bevan, number two. Probably Cracker Barrel, number three. Denny's Perkins.
Man, that's surprising for me.
I ain't, bro. Listen, I don't like Cracker Barrel syrup, so they gonna be middle of the pack for me.
Oh, you sleep, bro.
No, bro. Give me
you
that
sleep on Cracker
right
Barrel.
Out my cupboard, bro. And it's good.
Wait, Dennis, what you just say? You said
100%
like
pure maple. 100%
like
pure
syrup,
maple.
I don't like they syrup. Listen, it tastes too sweet to me. It
man, just bring your own sweet syrup to the spot, then man. Them pancakes go crazy at Cracker Barrel.
I think Bob Evans pancakes is better actually because they don't need syrup. Tastes like cake.
Can't talk and throwing like, shots, taking shots at Cracker Barrel. They don't need syrup.
They don't even need syrup, bro. I just take the pancake. The sauce patty, you fold it up and eat it like a sandwich.
I thought Dennis was going to say, I take the pancake and
no
eat it out my hand.
Put the egg. I put the egg in there too. Fried egg, fold it up in the.
official to it.
Hey, bro. Hey, the slap is crazy.
Yo, the load is crazy, though, bro. The
all right, let me hear somebody else, man, because that's a crazy list to me, bro.
I got you.
Yeah, bro. I feel like y'all sleep on Cracker Barrel, bro. Like, y'all really. But go ahead, bro. I'm going to let you go. One of y'all go.
So I got Denny's number one.
Oh, man. I don't want to hear the rest. I don't want to hear the rest.
Bob Evans number two.
I don't want to hear the rest, bro.
Number three, Perkins Waffle House.
Oh, hey, man. Yes.
Bro, is definitely number three, though. But you sleep on Waffle House, bro.
Yeah. Now, you sleep. Denny should not be nowhere near one, two, three, or four, bro. Denny should be number five on all of our lists.
Bro, it's my list.
Nah, bro.
All right, you're right. My bad. You're right. My bad. I can't tell you what it is.
That's my list, bro.
That's a valid That's a valid point. That's a valid point. I can't be mad at your list. All right, Carlin, what's yours, though? What's yours?
I feel like it's pretty easy. I feel like it's Cracker Barrel. I feel like it's Bob Evans. I feel like it's Waffle House, Perkins, Denny's.
Y'all sleep on Denny's.
I ain't that mad at that list, bro. Y'all really? So, hey, wait a minute.
Perkins
hold up,
bro.
Yeah, Perkins is trash.
Denny's is trash, too. When the last time y'all been at Denny's, bro? Like,
hey, man, that Grand Slam.
Yeah, so I'm trying to tell you that Grand
Slam. Yeah, Grand Slam was it in 2011, bro. But you been there lately, bro? That Grand Slam, you going to get a little pancake like this big, one little piece of bacon. Like,
I ain't been there in a while, man. I ain't been there in a while.
It's a reason you ain't been there in a while, though.
Y'all really don't like, but y'all really think Cracker Barrel is a number three? Yeah, Cracker Barrel is.
For me, yeah.
Cracker Barrel is kind of fire, bro, but
nah, bro.
I got Waffle House number one, though. I'm with you on that.
But you lived in Atlanta, though.
Bro, like Waffle House in Atlanta is way different.
That's a different
bro, you can go there any time of day, bro, and you're going to have the worst service ever, and it's going to be dirty. The menu going to be sticky and all that, but them waffles, I want all of it, bro.
That's like going to see Staples, bro. See, Staples ain't been right since they stopped having roaches, bro.
Yeah. Some places just got to be dirty, bro.
Real rap, though, bro.
Bro, if it ain't...
When they was in the little spot that had the one game in the lobby... They was much better than when they hit commercial.
Yeah, you're probably right. See, Staples was never all that to me, but yeah, I ain't mad at it.
Oh my gosh.
Nah, bro, but Waffle House in Atlanta is like, that's the spot, bro. Y'all sleep on Waffle House.
All right, so
bro, if it ain't,
maybe I go to Atlanta and I go to a Waffle House, I feel differently.
You probably would.
Hey, you're
from. But matter of fact, Carlin, I remember the first time I took y'all to Waffle House. The day of your wedding, actually, remember? I was like, y'all trying to give some breakfast?
Oh, yeah.
I was like, y'all ever been to Waffle House? Y'all was like, nah. I'm like, man, we going to Waffle House. Y'all like, Waffle House? I'm like, yeah, Waffle House. Bruh. Dante was like, yo, I ain't know Waffle House was hitting like this.
Hold on,
like,
wait. Y'all didn't get hip to Waffle House till Carlin got married, bro?
I was hip. They had never been. But we in Youngstown, bro. Like, by that time, I had been to Atlanta already. I had been like, yeah. But yeah, it's different. But yeah, it's dirty. It's gonna be a cat that look like he just fresh out the pen, making your food, probably sweating right on the bacon and all that,
bro,
wiping his face with the. Nah, it's good, bro. I'm telling you, that's a spot.
Right. Sweat and love,
bro. Waffle House, Cracker Barrel is definitely number two. I don't know how y'all even got anything else above Cracker Barrel on that list.
Yeah.
Bob Evans, Perkins, and then Denny's. Bob Evans smell. Every Bob Evans I go to smell like
smells amazing.
Old mop water, bro. It smell like old rags.
Nah, bro. Amazing, bro. It's the coffee with the sweetest pancakes you ever gonna get at a spot.
The sweetest.
Yo, Dennis, you don't need Dennis syrup, might, I might bro. Have to switch it. Butter, Bob Evans might syrup. Have to be number one right now, and Denny's number two, man.
I love Bob Evans.
Bob Evans,
bro.
Denny's number two.
We call it Roberts. Bro. We call it Roberts.
Roberts. Robert Dennison. Robert Evanson. I'm trying to go to Robert Evanson. Bro, my homie from Atlanta was up here. They don't got no Bob Evans in Atlanta, bro. He was like, yo, y'all got Bob Evans here? I'm like, bro, it's a Bob Evans on every exit you get off is a Bob
Evans.
Bob Evans like,
right there.
Like, yo, we got to go to Bob Evans. I'm like, all right.
Bob Evans is crazy.
I'm surprised y'all don't like Cracker Barrel like that, though. That's surprising.
Nah, they're not. You talking breakfast, though. You talking breakfast, bro. Cracker Barrel number three, bro.
Are we talking like cleanliness and stuff though? Cracker Barrel is like number one as far as cleanliness. It's clean. It's
They really are. That's
Y'all feel uncomfortable in Cracker Barrel, bro? My wife says she feel like it got racist vibes to it when she goes.
It do.
Yeah, bro.
It do.
Feel like some of my ancestors got shipped in some of them barrels, bro.
Yo, Carlin, you gotta calm down. Carlin, calm down. Hold up.
I don't feel uncomfortable, but it definitely got a different vibe, bro.
Yeah. I ain't really notice it until
the smell of the wood.
Bro, it's the pictures and stuff. They got pictures of like random. Them like white farmers and stuff just standing with pitchforks and stuff like
and then the smell of the wood, bro, the smell of the wood.
And then when you walk in, they got they got 75 rocking chairs just lined up outside. Like
right
I don't know why that feels racist to me. I don't know why. It's like
Carlin, calm down.
The big dumb checkerboard out there.
Carlin.
Right. What you going around here, boy? It's like,
dang.
That's what it's...
Pancakes?
Yo,
actually, I don't. I'm about to go
ahead
to Denny's,
pick your own.
Yeah, I'm going to Denny's.
I'm about to go to Denny's, bro. I'm not doing this with you. I'm not doing this with you, bro.
I'm going straight to Denny's. I'm going to Waffle House.
Yo, let me go to Bob Evans, man. What are you doing?
I feel like Waffle House is the opposite of Cracker Barrel, bro. Like white people might feel uncomfortable in Waffle House.
I feel uncomfortable in Waffle House. I'm like, I'm going. I'm trying to eat. Like, these guys. Listen, I don't. Oh man.
Cigarette ash all over.
Yeah, you, somebody got the AK sitting next to you. Nah, quit.
Right.
Oh man.
I went to Waffle House one time in Atlanta. These cats in the back smoking weed. The door is open, so I know they open. Because it ain't no sign that says closed. We walk in, they like, yo, we closed. It's takeout only. I'm like, bro, it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Like, what are you talking about, bro? Like,
we closed.
No, we closed. I'm like, these cats just do whatever they want here, bro. Like,
that's at every Waffle House.
But what can you say to them? You can't argue. Like, no, y'all open, bro. Come make my food. Like, what can you do?
Especially at that one, at Waffle House.
Yeah, we on the west side of Atlanta. Yeah, nah, I'm like, all right, we gonna go to, we about to go to Spring, we about to go to Sandy Springs. We'll catch y'all next time.
Oh man,
man. Hey, Atlanta Chick-fil-A is different than the mall though.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard it's crazy.
Talk about
it's crazy.
They got a Chick-fil-A with different food on it,
right? Yeah, they got like a menu with chicken pieces though. Like,
yeah, just one of them.
Like a chicken breast.
Bro, they got one with like pulled pork and stuff. They got stuff? Yeah. They got the Dwarf House got all types of
Dwarf
different
House.
Stuff.
Yeah.
They got a whole different menu.
Man, hey, listen, Caleb, man, don't hate, bro.
I ain't hate on nothing, bro. I'm just surprised that y'all got Denny's up there though. I ain't been to Denny's since I lived on the north side in Timber Ridge. That was the best spot.
Hey, listen, bro. So many memories, I can't get into it. But yeah.
Right.
Hey, Denny's is on the right lane. You needed a free meal?
Free meal.
Yo, we gotta calm down.
Calm down, man. Talking about if you need a free meal, like they just giving out free meals, like bro, what is
it? Northside Denny's. Yes. Northside Denny's for the free meal, bro.
Like, yo, I'm hungry. I don't got no food in the fridge, man. Y'all trying to hit Denny's real quick.
Let's go to Denny's.
My paycheck don't come till next week, man. Let's hit Denny's real quick.
It's only a certain time of the night that you gotta hit it though, where it's free.
Yeah, that's facts. It gotta be after midnight for sure. Yeah, it gotta be after the midnight.
Definitely after midnight.
This cat's talking about a free meal.
They just clearing inventory, bro. They clearing inventory.
And then and Perkins ain't been good since they took the one off the north side.
Yeah, that was the best one.
That was the best Perkins, bro.
Oh, there we go.
They took that off the north side. Denny's was trash. I mean, Perkins was trash after that, bro. You probably don't remember that, do you, Caleb? Or
what?
Carmen.
Perkins on the north side? I used to always go to the one in Boardman. I don't remember the north side.
Yeah, Perkins
used
to have one on the north, bro.
What we got next, bro?
I'm from the south side, though. We ain't really mess with the north side.
Yeah, I'm from the south side, too. We ain't with the Perkins on the north side.
We both is, and y'all both from the north side.
Yeah, I'm north side.
Nah, Dennis from the east side, bro. Dennis from Hubbard. Dennis from Hubbard, Liberty, north side, west side. You live on the west side, Austin town.
Yeah, all purpose.
Hey, y'all wanna? Oh, go ahead.
Have y'all seen this week how the rich is getting richer?
In what way? I mean, it's multiple ways, bro. I was gonna bring that up, bro. What we doing right now?
Man, bro.
Wait, how much they getting richer, bro?
They going for like six stacks, bro.
Wait, $6,000?
No, they starting at like. Yeah, they starting around
at like five. Yeah.
What y'all talking about?
Beyonce tickets for her tour. You don't got six racks, bro. You got to empty the whole savings account to go to that joint, bro. But how you? So all right, I'm gonna sound like a Beyonce hater once again, bro. Once again. I don't hate Beyonce, but look, nobody to me is worth that. Like I hate that's what gets on my nerves with artists like that. Like, bro,
it's just a couple hours.
I'm not paying that for nobody, bro. I'm sorry, like. And then the problem with me is like, bro, most of your fans can't afford that. Like, you ain't even making it affordable. I don't know if it's her fault, but like, it's not affordable for your fans that relate to you, that really want to see you. Like, only the rich people could come see you. You know what I mean? Like, her and like, I don't know. I feel like a lot of these artists, they talk about like, you know, empowering people and the culture and like, you know, in the hood and uplifting and stuff, bro. They can't even, bro. Nobody can afford them tickets unless they high class, like upper class, bro. And if they are, they shouldn't be buying those tickets. Nobody in the middle or lower class should be buying $6,000 tickets to see Beyonce, bro. That's y'all listening right now, listeners. If y'all considering buying those tickets and you make $75,000 or less a year, reconsider, because that's a bad use of money.
Do you know what you could do with it? Bro, that's for one ticket, bro. Do you know what you could do with the amount of money for two of those tickets? You know what I could get off for that? For 7 days? For like 14 days?
I told my wife that. I'm like, man, we could go to... I said, we can go to Italy for like 2 weeks or something like that. Man, like... So it's... I'm going to go to Beyonce concert or go to Italy for 2 weeks. Like, what we talking about,
2 weeks or 2 hours?
What we talking about, Ryan?
Like, man, that concert better be crazy, bro. She better be, like, levitating. She better be, like,
she better walk out of the hologram, bro.
Yeah, she better be.
Like, it better be a hologram. She walks out of the hologram and you just see her.
Yeah, and she just end up right in your face, right in my face, dancing right in my face. That's what Cass
is paying. Like, Cass is paying for how crazy her performance is about to be.
Right.
Like, they about to pay for some of the wildest stage you ever seen in your life. Because they all stadium.
Listen. Beyonce is great, bro. Beyonce is an amazing artist, amazing performer.
She's
going to
have a 100-yard stage, bro.
No reason for, like, I'm sorry, $6,000, bro.
Yo, just stay home, bro.
Yeah, I'm cool, man.
I'm sneaking in, bro. That's wild. I'm sneaking in. I'm a photographer.
Yeah, bro, just put a vest on and a badge that got your name on or something on it and make you look important, but they're not going to question you, bro.
Bro, listeners, don't listen to these two guys, man. At a Beyonce concert, they're going to take you right down to the ground.
Right to jail, bro.
But y'all don't think that's crazy how they, like, you think that they...
No, I think that is a crazy price, though. Six.
That's a wild price.
And Beyonce don't, like, she don't need that, bro. She's already a billionaire. Like, why you got to chart? Like, I don't get it, bro. I don't get that.
Listen, bro, you need to be able to spend a night with Beyonce for that amount of money.
Yeah, that's fact.
She gotta cook my family dinner. Like, what are you doing,
bro? I need just a private session of her just doing
whatever. Doing her whole performance right in front of you.
Yeah.
Hey, y'all say a la carte.
That is a crazy price, man.
Nah, that's nuts.
And Beyonce filed my taxes for me.
Yo, definitely try to write that off.
Yeah, bro, I don't get that.
If y'all could charge people that much money for something that she was doing, would you?
No.
If I could get that,
I could honestly say I would.
If I could get that off, yeah.
No, I'm not doing $6,000, bro.
I don't know that I'm doing nothing that is worth $6,000.
If I could get that off, I'm up.
I'm thinking about.
Just imagine 10. All right, imagine 10 people coming, bro. We good.
Yeah, you 10 up?
People, you
60
up,
grand, right?
That's some people
like,
solid for 2 years.
Bro, I'm like.
I might have to give it a shot, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
I'm just thinking about the people.
Look at Carter like, yeah, like, I might have to sue them.
I might be with you.
For a financial purpose, I might do one. But you think about the people who could afford to go to those concerts. Like, bro, who, like.
A lot of them is going to be celebrities.
Yeah, it's all celebrities, all rich people. Like,
or it's income tax season. I mean, what better time?
Bro, it's either rich people who can afford it.
Income tax.
That's what I'm saying. It's either rich people.
Bro,
who can afford
right
it?
Now, bro. It's happening right now.
Bro, think about how many people about to go bankrupt just to buy some Beyonce tickets, bro. Like, that's what I'm saying, bro.
That's crazy.
There's not a lot of people who know how to manage money in the world, right. If you think about it.
Bro,
like,
you seeing that even with the housing market, like a lot of foreclosures and stuff.
Bro,
like,
people don't know how to manage their money at all.
Hey, Mo, it's still foreclosing for like a couple thousand, ain't it?
Yeah. Seeing it, like how they, I mean... I got my theories. I feel like they kind of set everybody up, like,
it's definitely a setup. But you still gotta be smart with your money, like, fam. If you got bills to pay, don't buy tickets to a concert. Like,
yeah, just stay home. Like,
yeah, nobody's like forcing you to
pay your electric bill, bro. Like, yeah.
electric performance.
Pay your mortgage.
Yeah.
Do I want to have a house next month, or should I go to
mortgage or more stage?
Mortgage or more stage. This guy said mortgage or more stage.
There we go. Good job, Carlin. There we go.
Beyonce.
Yo, let's talk about these Grammys real quick, man. We might as well. When is the Grammys? Like next week? This weekend?
Tomorrow.
Do y'all care about the Grammys? I don't.
No,
but
I don't.
We might as well talk about who they got nominated, though.
I don't really care. I probably ain't gonna watch it, actually, for real.
Watch no
Grammys. I'm 100% not.
I don't watch no award shows, really. Like, I don't even know the last award show I watched.
Hey, you want to know the award show I watched, Dennis? I watched Champion of the Year. That's the award show I watch.
Champion of the Year, bro. That's where I'm at in life.
That must be life. Battle rap.
That's when they argue for, like, 5 hours on the top 20 battle rappers. And then whoever number one get, like, $6,000. Hey, look! They get $6,000 from
who
the
they
battle
get Champion of the Year for this year?
And then they go
see
Beyonce.
They didn't say it.
Okay. Bro, this is my beef with the Grammys, bro. I mean, I feel like if it's a true award, like, I don't know, I just feel like they should let the people vote. Like, who are these people that are making these decisions? And you can't tell me they sitting here analyzing these albums and songs and artists like, yo, this person made the best work because their production was on this. Like, nah, bro, like, it's just the popular people. Like, they gonna sprinkle some others in there to make it seem like, to make it seem real. But
right.
You can't let that be a fan vote, though.
Bro. I think you can.
No, because this is because fan base is bigger than music. Fan bases are bigger than music sometimes.
Kanye I think it West, would be more honest, though.
Not Kanye West, but like somebody like Beyonce, bro. Somebody like Beyonce, the Beehive will make Renaissance a Grammy winner.
Grammy winner, bro.
Beyonce gonna win Grammys either way.
They would because they look at the numbers.
But the
how many times
it will make it not even close.
So what is the Grammy supposed to be about? Is it supposed to be about how well these albums performed and did, or is it supposed to be about what's really the best music? Because it's clearly not that. All right, so if that's what it is,
I think it's performance, bro.
It has to be, bro.
It's numbers.
Because they're going to have cats like Jack Harlow and stuff on here, bro. We all know Jack Harlow album was trash. Like, they're going to have Beyonce on there. We all know her album was okay. Like, it shouldn't be on there as, like, R&B or whatever. Like, I don't know. But let's go.
I think fan voted be OD, though, bro. That'd be too crazy.
Maybe not a fan vote, but I just feel like it should be.
A percentage of the vote is weighted towards the board.
Yeah.
The other 50% weighted
something.
Then they said a previous Grammy winners vote like on it too.
Let it be peer voted, bro. Let it be peer voted. I wouldn't be mad at that.
That's what they say it is, though. That's what they say.
That's what
they're
saying.
Yes.
But it should
be a
peer like
vote of
hip hop
Grammy,
like,
Grammy winners.
But they're saying like country.
Nah, that ain't fair. I'm talking about hip-hop, yeah, like, you know, let the whole hip hop community vote on the hip hop album of the year. Because that's gonna be more. Yeah, that's gonna be more. That's gonna be more like legit to me.
But they never gonna do it because all like this, like they know every year.
Or put together like for hip hop, right? Put together a group of individuals who would know how to like unbiasedly analyze the music. You know what I'm saying? And let them be the ones who decide.
Right.
And do get your Joe Buttons, get your Charlemagne's, get your like you know what I mean? Like, get those guys.
I don't know about Joe in there. I ain't gonna lie.
I would. I think Joe has a good ear for music. Like,
I do too.
And he's unbiased. Like, I feel like it's people that he likes that he'd be like, yo, that album was trash. Like, that's the type of people you need to be. To me, that's the type of people you need on that. Like,
yeah, unbiased. Yeah. What's the list looking like, though, man? Right, we don't gotta go through the stuff we don't care about for sure, though.
Yeah, we're gonna skip to.
Like, I don't need to know like best techno rap album.
Toby and Wingwave is up for a new artist of the year. He ain't gonna get it, but that's fine.
Who all on there though? Like, how's he new?
That's what I'm saying.
Cause he blew up this year, bro.
But we been.
I don't know none of these other names on there except Lotto.
Lotto win.
Lotto probably win that. All right,
so hit the category and then hit.
All right, let me go back. Let me go. Let's see.
Yeah, shit.
All right, overall album of the year, you got Adele 30.
That was fire.
Brandy, Carly, In These Silent Days, Renaissance. Told you, bro, it was gonna be on there. Bad Bunny. Un Verano Sin Ti.
Sin Ti. This cat was sad, bro.
Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. Good Morning, Gorgeous. DJ. Oh, Mary J. Blige. It's Mary J. Blige. Voyage. ABBA. I don't know who that is. Music of Spheres. BTS. Lizzo Special. I didn't even know Lizzo dropped the album this year. And then you got Harry's House. Harry Styles. I've only heard two of these albums.
I heard.
I probably heard like one and a half.
I heard
BTS
some of that.
BTS might win. Is that the K-pop group?
Oh yeah, they go crazy. That's the Japanese dudes, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, them Japanese guys.
Win,
yes.
Gonna
bro,
win
they going
just
crazy.
Just because like the numbers.
their numbers.
Nah, I think it's gonna be either Beyonce or Adele though. Just again because of the popular vote, or Harry Styles. Harry Styles been everywhere this year.
Yo, we saying what's the best album? Or like
no, that's what I'm saying. This who gonna win that?
Oh, okay.
Based on the Grammy votes.
Oh, based on the Grammy. Probably, yeah, I can see that.
But I would out of those, I would
Adele.
Choose.
I wouldn't be
surprised if Bad Bunny won too, though.
Yeah, Adele, Bad Bunny, and whoever. What y'all say, Harry Styles?
And
the K-pop. Those four are probably the top of that.
Song of the year. I'll tell y'all some of them.
I would like to see
Kendrick
win just because of the content. His content heavier than all these other cats, but
yeah, this ain't gonna be Kendrick's year.
This ain't gonna be his year.
Not for album of the year. He probably get rap album of the year, but I don't think overall.
Adele probably gonna. I'm thinking about it. It might be more Adele.
Song of the year, they got Beyonce, Break My Soul. I'm just going through some of them. I ain't about to read all these because I don't even know who some of these people are. About Damn Time, Lizzo, God Did. They got God Did up there.
God,
the Heart Part 5, Kendrick.
Oh, that ain't gonna make it.
That ain't gonna make it.
They probably gonna go Break My Soul.
They'll probably go, hold on, that's all? That's it?
No, that's more. I just don't know the rest. I don't know. Oh, the Taylor Swift is on there too, so she'll probably
Taylor win. Swift might win, bro.
Man, forget these categories, bro. Where's the hip hop at, bro? All right, here we go. Rap Album of the Year. God Did, DJ Khaled. I Never Liked You, Future. Pusha T, It's Almost Dry. Jack Harlow, Come Home, The Kids Miss You. And Miss Him Around, The Big Steppers. Bro, get Jack Harlow out of here. Why is he on this list?
There is a clear winner here.
Why is he on this list, bro?
How mad would y'all be if Jack Harlow actually take that home?
He probably would, though. He would, bro.
It's like Macklemore.
Yeah, that's the equivalent, bro. Macklemore beating Kendrick for Good Kid, M.A.A.D. City.
At least Macklemore had a hit, though. Like, Macklemore had a hit. This cat
Jack Harlow got that song with Drake. That's it, bro. That song is like 3 years old, ain't it?
I think so. Off
the first class.
Oh yeah, it was. Yeah, you're right. That was the hit, though. That was a hit. That was a smash.
That was a slap. Yeah.
I would say rap. What y'all got on this though?
Say it one more time, the list.
God Did, DJ Khaled. No. I Never Liked You, Future.
No.
You don't think so? That could be.
I don't think so.
Pusha T, It's Almost Dry, Jack Harlow, and then Mr. Brown and the Big Steppers.
It's going to be either Kendrick, Jack Harlow, and Pusha T.
I think Future got a chance, bro. Future, if we talking about performance, bro, Future album did great this year.
And Khaled, like, they saying Khaled might have Jay-Z showing up, so I can see
Jay-Z is performing, so yeah.
I can see them giving that to Khaled just because he got Jay-Z to show up.
And that's how they do it, too, though, right?
Yeah.
A lot of times, yeah.
The performance is getting the win.
But that album wasn't good, though. It wasn't that good.
That's what I'm trying to say.
At the Grammys in 2023, he might get Song of the Year, too.
Yeah.
I might have to watch, because he going to rap that whole verse, bro. They going to let this cat rap that whole verse live?
Bro, already know it's going to be dramatic, too. It's going to... Oh, I might have to
watch. Hov might come out and do something different. Like, he might rap a whole different verse, flexing in a whole different type.
He might stand flat-footed with a mic on a stand and just give you that
verse
acapella. Give you that verse acapella, bro.
Right. Acapella. Cut the whole beat out.
I ain't gonna lie, that's kind of tougher than what I thought, just looking at it. Just looking at some of these names on here.
Yeah, it is, though.
Jack Harlow shouldn't be on there, but other than that.
No, yeah, the other four, I'm not mad at that. Well, I don't think DJ Khaled should be there either. I don't think that album was that good.
I thought it was a solid album. I don't think it should be there either.
Grammy, though? I don't think it was Grammy
worthy. No, I don't think it should be there. It was way too much better
Future,
rap
Kendrick, album, and Pusha. Those are the three I think one of them three should win. Their albums were way better than...
Say it again. Future,
Kendrick, and Pusha. Those three are way, like, way, way, way better.
Yeah.
I'm just going on what I think it's going to be, though.
It's going to be DJ Khaled.
Jack Harlow is going to get an award, bro.
Yo, if Jack Harlow won Best Rap Album, he's going to win something. Like, over Pusha T.
It might be
If Jack Harlow wins anything in hip-hop, that proves he's an industry player.
Yo, I'm coming to diss you, Jack
like,
Carlo.
He got no reason to.
In hip-hop, bro. We diss
he got no business. And then because he is talented, though. I ain't gonna dog him, but that album was not good. Like, his first one was better than that. Yeah.
I can see what you're saying, Dennis.
R&B Song of the Year. Jasmine Sullivan, Hurt Me So Good. Mooney Long.
Money
Hers
Long.
And Hers.
Money Long.
Oh, I ain't never heard that.
She knows.
Beyonce,
Cuff
It.
Hours and Hours, right?
Yeah, Hours and Hours. Yeah.
Hours and Hours and Money
oh,
Long.
Oh, Hours and Hours. Okay. PJ Morton, Please Don't Walk Away, and Mary J. Blige, Good Morning Gorgeous. I don't really know none of these songs.
PJ Morton up for Grammys on this?
Yeah.
That's fire, bro. He made good. He made good music, bro.
Listen,
that's...
bro, that Money Long got a good chance.
Damn.
I have to hear that
the
song.
The Hours and Hours song? I could do this for hours. The Hours and Hours song, bro. Okay. That only been one of the biggest songs of the year for money.
Taylor probably heard it. He probably just don't know.
I just ain't know who it was.
Yeah, you probably heard it.
There's Money Long.
Well, if Jay-Z showing up, Beyonce showing up, so that's they might give it to her.
They can't give Beyonce R&B song of the year, man. She didn't even have... Was that even an R&B song?
Virgo's Groove. I ain't gonna remember.
Beyonce might get the Grammy, bro. Just coming off these.
She's gonna get a Grammy.
That's not R&B.
Coming off these tour prizes.
She's gonna get a Grammy. I don't know what category. Rap Song of the Year, Pushing P.
I hope not.
Churchill Downs, Drake and Jack Harlow. God Did. Wait for You, Drake and Future, and Kendrick the Heart Part 5. They got the Heart Part 5 in a lot of these categories.
God
I'm surprised,
bro. Get that one, though.
Yeah, that has to.
God
that one
did,
has to.
God Did might get might have a three-peat on the rise, bro. For real. If you think about
Dreadlocks, Face
of the Year,
Chips, I'm the Apex.
Rap Song of the Year. And then what was the other one you said God Did was
on? The Apex.
Oh, Khaled.
Yeah.
Bro, if Hov is performing, two of those is theirs.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna be album of the year, but it'll be song.
Rap Song of the Year. I could see that. What bigger rap song? I mean, some of these were more.
I'm surprised Hov is so nominated.
It was more of a moment than what Jay-Z.
I don't think so, bro.
Kendrick popping out with the. I'm talking about the total. I'm not even talking Kendrick fan. I'm talking about total package. Like him popping out with like that song, the music video, what was going on, having Nipsey.
That video,
you know what I'm saying?
That video
I'm not saying it as like.
It should be video of the year.
I don't think it was a bigger moment, though. I don't think it was a bigger moment. I think it was a big moment because we knew the album was coming, so it was like highly anticipated, but I feel like that. I don't know, bro. That song.
Her part five with like, the change on their faces, bro. The video is what the song is, bro. Yeah. It's the video.
Yeah,
what
that's true.
Any other Kendrick song, I would agree with that. Like, if anything on Mr. Morale, I probably would like. But just the video, how he like packaged it, like.
I feel like it came and went faster than God did, though. I feel like it came and went faster than God did because his album follows. So like after the album came, people ain't going back to the heart, like.
And then Hov is going to his album. Hov is just nostalgia. It's just nostalgia when Hov.
That God did song
is different.
Yeah. It's completely different songs. I don't know. It'll be interesting.
I would be happy to see either of those.
It should be one of those two.
I don't want to see none of these other songs win. That's what I think.
It should be one of them two.
Church Hill Down should not be on here.
That shouldn't even be on here, man.
Like, Wait For You was a big song. I'm not mad at that. But compared to these two, I don't know. Yeah, I wouldn't be mad. Either one of those.
One of those two should win it. That's what I think. Because they both are moments. Like Jay-Z popping out was like 4 minute verse. You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
Talking about his whole career, like.
And Wayne's verse.
Yeah.
Wayne's verse was hard, bro.
The GOAT.
Wayne.
Yeah, it was.
Oh, Wayne.
Jay heard it and was like, oh, I need.
Y'all feel like Ross slid on the track too, but I feel like.
He shouldn't have been on the track, bro.
I feel like it should have been. I feel like after Hove recorded his verse, it should have been Wayne and Hove, and they should have let Wayne rap for like. 3 more minutes and just let him and Hov both go back to back like 4 minutes on that track.
Yeah, 8 minutes. Yeah.
That should have been that's Mr. Carter.
Imagine them nostalgia on that joint, bro. Like, cuz you know Wayne was just getting started, like he could have cooked for like 2 more minutes easy. Like Wayne could have went.
But I'm just saying, not get what you're saying though, Young.
It wouldn't have been such a lopsided track. Like timing wise.
I get you.
They said timing Jay wise.
After Wayne, so you know what I'm saying?
Oh, you know he did.
Jay was like, nah, he doing this.
Look at Dennis Jr., though. Check out the young boy, Dennis Jr.
Man, you're looking for tomorrow,
what up, bro. Man? What up? Oh, yeah, that's what Kai do, too.
That's what they do.
Bro, chill, bro. I just like, got you. Relax. You
that's like how it be, bro. Relax. he giving me, and he looking for tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Cool,
what up, Denim? I want to hold this cat, bro. I didn't even get a chance to hold him last time, bro. I didn't even get a chance to hold him when I seen him last time. I don't care about none of these other joints, bro.
Straight to the mouth.
Here go tomorrow, son.
Unless y'all want to talk about Spoken Word album.
Wait, what?
Spoken Word album of the year. They got Questlove on there.
I
want him to win, bro.
I guess so.
Right. There's my winner right there.
Jamie Foxx got a Spoken Word album, I guess.
Hey, bro, Cass is just out here for the money grab.
Hey, what about the R&B album of the year, Youngs?
I don't see it on there, though.
I seen, they said Mary J. Blige, Good Morning, Gorgeous.
I think I said it already.
Yeah,
dude.
You said it. Yeah.
Oh, you said that. I thought we said the song. I ain't know the album. My bad.
Where is it at, though? I don't even see it on this list.
Number 22. It say, like, Breezy, Black Radio.
Oh, no. He didn't go over that.
Candy Drip and Watch the Sun by P.J. Morton.
Ooh. Same again?
Good Morning Gorgeous by Mary J. Breezy by Chris Brown. Mm-hmm. Black Radio 3 by Robert Glasper. That was crazy. Candy Drip by Lucky Day. And Watch the Sun by PJ Morton.
Hey, that Good Morning Gorgeous might get that.
Yeah, I can see. Yeah. That's a tough category because all those are fire. But I'm going to give it to. I think Mary J. going to win it.
Yeah, Mary J.
I think she's going to win it. I personally like Lucky Day's album better than. Pretty much all of those except Breezy. I think Breezy should have a chance to win that too.
Breezy,
man.
I feel like Breezy,
especially
should have a
the deluxe. Sure, when he put the deluxe out, I'm like, yo, you put these songs on the deluxe.
But ain't no way they giving Chris Brown a Grammy.
But
they wouldn't even let him do a performance for Mike. Bro.
Yeah, he ain't getting no Grammy. Hey, and man. He only sold like 60 first week or something like that. He not getting that. They kind of played my boy Giveon though. I think Giveon should have been on there, bro. He deserved a spot.
You thought that album was big enough to be a Grammy now?
Yeah, bro. He's one of the biggest new artists. He should be in one
that
of these.
That kind of came and went, though, bro.
Comparative to these other five.
It did. For the majority.
For the fan, it didn't, but, like.
Yeah, I'm going to give you on a fan.
Yeah.
That's true. Yeah, I'm cool, bro. I'm not watching the Grammys. Forget the Grammys, bro.
Hey, man, listen, man. I might just have to watch it from when Jay-Z performed. I need to see
yeah,
that.
I need to see that. That's the only thing I need to see.
And then they supposed to be doing a Quavo's supposed to be doing a tribute to Takeoff with Maverick City.
What? For real?
What? Yeah, I read something on that.
That's okay.
What's this?
I'm here for that.
Yeah, Quavo.
I'm all the way into that. Maverick City and Quavo.
I don't know, but listen, I don't know if Quavo is doing a tribute like he's just speaking, and then Maverick City is doing a performance. I don't think they're doing their performance together, though. I think it's like Quavo is going to talk, do you know how they do,
yeah.
And then Maverick City is going to maybe do a song to commemorate.
I hope they don't do that, bro. Man, shout out Maverick City, man. But it's crazy because Maverick City, bro. So when I was in Atlanta, Mavericks, that's when they started. And it just started out as like some writers just getting together and just like making music. This was like during the pandemic. It was small. Like it wasn't even nothing big. Like they were kind of known locally. Bro, by like the next year, they the biggest gospel group in the world, bro. Like in the whole world. It's crazy. Like, it's just nuts, bro. They grew so quick. But they super fire, though. Shout out
to them. So we just need to go to Atlanta, bro.
I'll take one joint, bro.
Like, a lot of them sung in the choir for, like, different gospel artists. Like, I think one of them sung for, like, Fred Hammond or something. And one of them was with, like, Elevation. It's just a whole bunch of random people that just came together and just was like.
Man, let's do our own thing, man. Let's stop putting money in Kirk.
And they went crazy. They
Let's
went crazy.
Kirk.
Right. All right. Yeah, they went crazy. Shout out to Maverick City.
Hey, Lakers cooking right now. Yeah, this is going to be a 160-point game.
Come on, man. I need Bron to get that 63, bro. I need Bron to get that 63.
He ain't going to get it tonight.
Come on, man. Tonight. Come on, Bronny. Nah. Yeah, it's already third quarter or fourth quarter. Nah, third.
What else we got on the Grammys?
Nothing, bro. That's all I got.
I got a question for y'all, man. Speaking of the Grammys, man. Just going back to the Chris Brown, man. Do y'all think, like, there should... I don't know how to word it. Like, there should be, like, a statute of limitations when, like, you should be able to thrive again.
Move on with your life? Yeah bro.
Like, because the people that you hurt the worst moved on. Forgave you and moved on.
But Rihanna is bigger than ever right now. Rihanna's doing the Super Bowl.
Why can't society do the same thing? Like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. I think Chris Brown is well-deserving of a lot. And it's just one bad moment that's taking his whole career.
Bruh, if that,
like, he's a GOAT. Like, it ain't like
he's
like
a GOAT.
It ain't like
he's
like
GOAT.
An average artist. Like, he's legitimately
He's the best. Like, arguably you know the best. He could arguably be the best ever, bro, in that category.
Like R&B, yeah. He I mean, out
here. Yeah, bro. Like, if his image was never tainted, he might be unarguably the best right now. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
He could unarguably, like, without a doubt, be, like, on top.
Because he would have had all the accolades. You know what I'm saying? Like all you know, them. You know how everybody got go to, oh, we got 21. Like, Chris could have had all
bro, Chris things. Brown, because he's like, yeah, bro. Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know.
I didn't want to say what I was going to say because Cat's going to get fired up. But I'm.
I think they're doing Chris bad, man.
Yeah.
They doing Chris bad, bro, man.
Bro, it's the same situation with a lot of these artists, bro. Like, that's why I told y'all Tory will never get to that level again, ever. Like, he's done.
Yeah, especially.
Well, he got to get out first, though. He got to get out first.
Yeah, even that. I think he's done, bro. He might still make make music on it, like, but he ain't going to be back to that level again.
Hey, he got
to
get Dummy of the Day. I just thought about it, bro.
He's Tory? Gonna, I admit it. He definitely going to have an I admit it.
Bro, what Tory do?
He was on the phone and, like, The way you just talked, like, bro, you don't know they recording you.
He might be dummy at it. What's wrong with you? Like, he might be dummy at a pandemic.
Oh, you talking about the phone recording? Yeah, bro.
Yeah, that's
he might be dummy at a pandemic.
All right, bro.
That's so dumb. You are really dumb. For real.
Dummy of the pandemic.
Y'all just thought about that. Like, y'all talking about it played in my head. Like, that was bad.
Yeah, because on the pod, one of y'all said it. Like, did y'all hear that phone conversation? I'm like, nah. I'm like, let me check it out after we recorded. I'm like, yo, that was bad.
Yeah, that was dumb, bro.
That was just bad. And they're like, man, I promise, man. You know, if I wasn't drunk, I wouldn't have did nothing like that, man. It was just, you know. I'm like, bro, you sound dumber than a mug right now.
Yeah,
like,
bro.
In jail, right? Man, but he's like, in jail, right?
Bro, welcome to your new home, bro.
Yeah.
Welcome home.
Yeah, welcome home.
Yo, welcome.
Welcome home to jail. It's horrible, bro. Welcome home. Oh, man.
What y'all think about Riri on the ball, though?
I'm hyped for it, bro. I love Riri.
Yeah, man.
Riri is, yeah. I love Riri. I hope we get some music from it. I hope we get some music from it.
Do y'all think she gonna drop?
That's her rollout, bro.
Yeah, she got to.
Didn't she get, like, an award for, like, a song? I don't know. I feel like I heard recently she got like a song of the year or something. And I'm like, did she even drop though?
It was on a Black Panther soundtrack.
Yeah, but she sung like two words on that song. It wasn't even a full song. It was literally like an intro. Like that. That's what one song. Like, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
whatever it was.
Cat Carlin got loud as heck.
Lift
me up. Hold me down. Yeah, bro. These big artists can do anything and they gonna win an award. They just come out of nowhere and sing two notes and it's like, yep, Grammy. Like,
Grammy,
man, that's what I've been talking about.
Grammy,
like,
Grammy.
Like, she barely, that song got three words in it, bro. Like,
y'all boys get to that little boat yet?
I didn't, bro. I probably won't, cuz I'm trying to tell y'all, man. I'm gonna get to that boat, man. I don't know when TDE. Y'all might have misplayed this one. You ain't getting into it, bro. You ain't getting into that. Stop lying, bro. TDE, y'all might have misplayed this one, dog. I'm telling y'all, TDE.
Yeah, they might have misplayed this, man.
What do you mean by that?
They might have miscalculated this, man.
Oh, what, the Grammys?
Like that?
This album is amazing.
The boat like that?
This is amazing, bro. I never thought I'd say anything about this, like, from Lil Yachty.
I ain't never going to put Lil Yachty and Amazing in the same sentence, at least until I listen to it, bro.
Wait till you hear this, bro. All
right.
I can't believe it, though. He's been quiet for a long time, though.
Because he said he wanted to make a rap album, and then out of nowhere, he dropped this. Like, hey, you didn't
make
rap.
Yeah, I don't want to hear him rap at all. I don't ever want to hear him rap at all.
Yeah, it was.
I don't even want to hear him say rhyming words together in a sentence.
Hey, y'all cats like that Kanye. Y'all gonna like this, man. I'm telling y'all.
Oh, okay. It's like that?
It's musical, bro. It's very musical.
I bet. Yeah, I'm gonna get to it. I'm gonna get to it.
Like off the rip.
Hey, I seen something drop. Styles P drop. Did y'all get to that?
Yeah.
I saw that. I didn't get to that.
SP, man.
Styles P always comes with bars.
Styles P keep retiring, though. I thought he was done.
No, I think, I don't know. I can't even keep up with
Between him and
Tom Brady.
And him, Brady, and Westside Gunn, that's 12 retirements in 2 years.
And Logic.
And Logic.
And Logic dropped too, bro. Y'all ain't get to that Logic album?
Wait, he dropped a new album?
Yeah, bro.
I'm never listening to Logic.
I don't know why Logic keeps coming up on my feed. Like, I don't care about this cat no more, man.
Logic was your man, though.
He was, bro, back when he could actually rap. Now he just saying words. Like, bro, you suck. Bro, you the biggest cornball, bro. How you retire and then drop 7 albums in 2 years after your retirement? Like, that's the stupidest marketing stunt ever.
Rappers don't retire, bro, until they just out of there. Like, rappers don't retire, bro, until they just disappear.
Right.
Joe might be the only one who really retired, bro. Like, he is not rapping, bro.
Y'all heard
like,
Westside almost had
he retired and ain't bro. Spit a bar since.
I think Joe would give a 16 for the right.
You think so?
Westside almost had it, bro.
I was listening to a podcast. He did?
Yeah, Westside had all the Slaughterhouse. And he said what? he was talking about it on an interview. He said like everybody was with it, and then they started beefing, bro.
They started dissing each other.
Westside said he just decided not to do it.
Ah, Wes. West.
Humble
I think some bro, if Slaughterhouse got together and dropped the album right now, it would go crazy, bro.
Like, what are we talking about?
Just offer Joe himself.
I mean, you got Royce, who's one of the GOATs.
Nah, yeah, I know that, but I'm just
and
saying,
then Joe.
Just Joe with the
Joel Ortiz the and Crook already been active. They already been active, and then Joe, man,
they
come on,
have,
man.
Yeah, Joe, yeah.
I would love that. I would love to hear that, bro.
Yeah, I'm here for it. I'll be here for another Joe
Royce,
album.
Bro. It's overdue, bro.
Bro. It is due for some Royce.
Overdue, bro. The Allegory was what 2020.
Yeah, great album. Yeah. Great album. I love that album still to this day. Mm-hmm. To this day. Yeah, man.
Yeah, I feel like we gotta say Happy Black History Month, man.
Man, yeah, man.
Black History Month.
Man, it's too late in the pod to be doing that. We should did that early, man.
Yeah, man, we tripping.
I was just thinking history about that. Month, Black people, this our month to go act ignorant.
You know,
hey, bro, I was at work wilding. I was like, y'all got something to say to us?
Hey, I read a post.
Carl, I do the same stuff. I be doing that at work, too, man.
I read a post on Facebook. It said, Happy Black History Month to the dark skins. This is our time. The light skin got Easter, though. Y'all can get Easter.
What?
Easter? That's giving them Easter, though. Easter. How you guys share a holiday with Jesus? Like, come on, bro. That ain't fair.
Light skin people can get Easter. That's crazy.
Dang.
That's such a light skin holiday, though. Like,
it is, bro.
Easter,
so
like 4th of July or something. Oh, yeah, I don't know. But they get the light colors. Cats wearing
colors,
purple
pastels.
And light blue and stuff. Yeah.
Light colors and squinted eyes, baby.
Light colors and squinted eyes.
Hey, what's the artist y'all listen to that y'all like? I ain't gonna say be ashamed, but like y'all wouldn't tell
Logic.
Anybody y'all listen to.
Logic.
Oh.
I was listening to that Logic from 2015.
Hey, Mo, you gonna let me go to my. Now I gotta go back to my title. And see.
That people would be surprised, or
yeah,
what
people
you
that
mean?
You surprised that you listen to.
Dang, I don't
FK know. Twigs.
Yeah, I'm surprised about that.
Yo, I can't. All the ones I would say, I already said on the podcast. So
I mean, Cardi B. I'm always here for Cardi B. That's okay. But the people know it though. That ain't people already know that about me.
No, they wouldn't expect that though. Like if they don't know,
yeah,
they wouldn't
yeah,
expect Kendrick
yeah,
to be
true.
Pulling up in an Invasion of Privacy. Like this go hard. It's hard.
Hey man, that's a good.
Mine is always Taylor Swift, bro. I gotta go with Taylor Swift, man.
Oh, if we talking about like any
yeah,
genre,
any genre.
Oh man,
cause you know people look at people look like we hip hop, like we still listen to everything else.
Hey, I'll be honest with y'all. I got one. I got one, bro. I gotta say it, bro. Dude is mad. He going crazy right now, but his music is still fire. Sam Smith, bro.
Hey, hold on, you listen to a new album?
Sam Smith is dope, bro. I don't care what nobody says. That dude is fire.
Is his new album hard?
Yes, bro, it's good. He out there wearing booty shorts and all that, but his music is good. Bro, look at this dude, bro. Like,
yeah, I know.
He just looks silly. Like,
I seen him on Saturday Night Live, bro, on the commercial.
He leaned all the way
nuts,
into it.
Man, looking nuts.
This guy looking crazy, bro. What's wrong with him?
I don't care. His music is hard, bro.
He said like, with a straight face.
Hey, bro, I don't know. Like, I don't really
know. Yeah, dude. Booty shorts and all that.
He could sing, bro. Nah, Sam Smith, man. Don't sleep on him, bro. That's mine. That's my sleeper.
Dang, I don't know, bro.
Dennis don't got no sleepers, bro. He only listen to like.
I listen to a lot of mainstream now. Like, I don't listen to music much, but
right.
Carlin probably got some country artists that he mess with.
See, I knew he was going there, bro. I ain't even like that. It ain't I know even you like
do,
that.
Bro. I know you do, bro. I know your in-laws put you on in some country, bro.
I don't, bro.
It ain't nothing to be ashamed of, bro.
Curly, you don't be bumping to Luke Bryan, you ain't,
bro. You've been in Missouri too long, bro, to not be hip to no country, bro.
Carlin got to bump to Luke Bryan.
I really don't, bro. All
right.
Like, if it's on in the car and my wife got it playing, I'm like, I've been playing 21 Savage for 4 days, so I guess.
yeah, you gotta go with a Luke Bryan or Luke Combs.
Hey, bro,
or whatever.
I've been in my Ludacris area codes bag.
Luda?
Ooh,
only sure. Area code, though. I just keep playing that. Nate Dogg.
Nate Dogg is so hard, bro.
Nate Dogg is too hard, bro.
King of hooks, bro. The hook king. But my wife busted out the other day singing something. It was a DMX song. I was like, what'd you know about that? She was like, bro, she was offended. Like, you don't think I know that song? I'm like, and it wasn't like one of his bigger songs. It was like one of his like B cuts or something. I was like, yo. Right. I'm like, yo, what?
Oh, man.
That moment's been catching me off guard.
Probably the only Glorilla, probably.
Glorilla?
Yeah, that's surprising.
I can see that. I can see that. I like Lotto, I mean, but I don't think that's too crazy. Like, I used to listen to Lotto last album like all the time though.
Nah, I wouldn't.
My wife put me on. She was going crazy on that joint.
I wouldn't be seeing you listening to it all the time, but yeah.
Bruh, listen, like once a week for at least like for at least like 2 months. Yeah.
Oh, y'all go peep that Sam Smith though.
Nah.
Just straight up, like, I think I won't.
Nah. And what else we got, bro? We didn't do a whole pod not talking about nothing, bro. This one.
Yeah,
of them.
Man. The pod about nothing.
Pod about nothing, baby.
The Seinfeld, man. Yeah. We need Seinfeld to narrate this joint. Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
I've been watching Seinfeld. It's so funny, man. I got to go back and watch it.
Hey, watch, what's it called? It's a movie on Netflix. I started watching it, but I ain't finished it. That joint is so funny, bro.
You People. Boys in
the You People. People. Yeah. Man, y'all watched it?
Good, bro.
It's funnier than a mug. I started watching it. I'm like, I got to wait for my wife. Like, we got to watch this together.
Yeah,
it's
one
of them.
You got to wait for your wife. Yeah.
Hey, somebody told me about it, man. I mean, there's a, you want to watch a mad racist movie? I'm like, no, I don't want to watch that. That's how somebody told me
nah,
about it.
Nah, it ain't racist. It's funny.
I mean, it's just super.
It's over the top, bro.
It's way over the top, but it's
like
funny.
Really.
That joint is. They were saying it was like everybody. I'm like, all right.
Nah, it's like it's humor. Like it's like how you would view like Dave Chappelle. Like you know what I mean? They're making light of stuff, but it's mad fun. I thought it was funny. I thought that joint was hilarious.
Yeah, I loved it, bro. I wasn't expecting that. I wasn't expecting Jonah Hill to be that different in that role. Like he's still him, he's still funny, but that role is way different than what you used to Jonah Hill doing. Like,
right.
He ain't out smoking weed all day.
Yeah.
Like making funny. It ain't super bad Jonah Hill. Like
right.
This was a good one. Mature Jonah Hill, I like mature Jonah Hill. Like.
That giant
Lauren London was did great in that too though, man. It was good to see her.
Yeah, she put on some weight. I ain't know she got
she did,
chunky
though.
Like
she
that.
Did. She look good still.
She still looks great though. Yeah,
yeah
still
Nunu
looks great.
Still at it.
Still got a Picasso in her house.
Yeah. You got a Picasso in your house.
You got a Picasso in your house.
Bro, that joint. Hey, that's a classic ATL moment, bro.
That's why
Picasso
you started going to Waffle House.
Right.
Just stayed at Waffle House.
Hey, what shows y'all been watching though? I got like four shows I've been watching weekly though.
Yeah, I got some shows too,
bro.
What's y'all on right now?
I've been on that.
And Caleb said it, and I instantly forgot what I was.
I'm on that.
Cali, I got shows. What is it?
I got like three or four. So I'm on the. Of course, BMF is good right now.
Yeah.
Your Honor is good.
I didn't get to that.
Y'all ain't seen Your Honor.
It's a new season.
That's two of mine. Yeah, you got the same
out.
Two. Yeah.
Okay. And then the other one was PMF Your Honor. Dang, what's the last show? It'll come back to me.
The game.
But yeah, those two right now is
you watching the new The Game, Dennis?
The game, no, I ain't been back on the new game. I ain't got to it yet. I ain't got to the best man series either yet.
Yeah, I got to that.
Bro, I got away from just starting everything, bro. I need to finish some stuff first.
I don't like the once a week releases, bro. It's annoying.
The other one is Godfather Harlem. New season.
Ooh, that's a good one. I stopped watching that for whatever reason, but I need to get back to it. I was watching the first season. Yeah. Forrest Whitaker.
I need that Doogie.
Yeah, those is all solid. Mayor of Kingstown. I don't know if y'all watched that. Season 2 is out.
So I plan to get on that. I started Mayor of Kingstown a while ago. But I only got through like the first two episodes.
Bro, if you get to the end of the first season, it goes crazy.
Okay.
All right, I'm gonna get back to that.
And then season 2 is starting off solid. Your Honor is great.
Yeah.
Man, I don't know if I'm getting soft, bro, but like I love BMF, but like some of these scenes be too violent, bro. Like it'd be like over the top. Like, man, this cat, like
the little dude Lamar, you talking about the dude Lamar?
Lamar is nuts, bro.
He's going wild.
He's killing everybody with his bare hands. Like, bro, it's sick, bro. I don't know if having a kid made me like soft, but that one scene where he smashed the freaking piece of wood through the dude's face. I'm like, bro, come on. I don't need to see all that. Yeah, like, it was too much. Like, it made me feel uncomfortable. Like, why am I watching this right now? Like, yeah.
Echo 9 on Apple TV.
Echo 9? Okay.
Yeah, it's like...
Oh, you got money. It's like... Nah, that's the one thing I don't got is Apple TV.
Nah, you probably do got it, bro. You got Apple products, bro. Yeah. We all got Apple Pro. I just used the free subscription. Yeah. That's it.
Oh, it's free?
Right. Yeah, you get the Apple TV.
You get like 6 months free, bro.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And Severance is on there too.
Severance. I heard Severance was
good.
Too.
Yeah, I heard that was good. Yeah, there's some good shows out right now. You is coming back. You is coming back next week.
I heard about that.
Wu-Tang
Power's coming back.
Wu-Tang. That's one of my favorite shows. Wu-Tang.
Power Ghost is coming back.
Dennis, you think Ghost dead, Dennis?
No.
I don't either.
I don't think so. I think he's gonna make an appearance at some point. I just gotta get the money right. Yeah. Hey, speaking of, I don't know, Mark.
This cat Mouth.
That King Show started walking with King.
His Mouth's over there crying. That's your baby crying, Mouth. I just hear babies crying. I don't know whose it is, bro. We all got babies.
Yeah. Hey,
my bad.
Y'all still
what? Nah, you good.
What was I just talking about? Because I was about to say something.
He's talking about shows. He said something about ghosts. Ghosts and...
Oh, ghosts ain't
dead. Oh. Back to that. Everything outside of Power, bro. Amari Hardwick is one of the corniest cats in the world.
Bro, I tell Rachel that all the time, bro.
Bro, I cannot...
Bro, he a fake... This is Amari Hardwick every scene, bro. I'm like, for real, okay?
Bro, we was watching the movie the other day.
Wait, who is that, bro? I don't watch this show.
Her work is Ghost. That's Power, Ghost, bro.
I know what you're talking about. Okay.
Yeah, bro. Oh,
he cornier than Michael B. So... He cornier than Michael B.
He might have a corny off, bro.
He might people, be number one. He's number one for sure.
I gotta say this. I should have said it earlier.
Tasha.
People be killing me for my Michael B. taste, calling him a trash actor and a cornball and all that. Watch his SNL stand up. Watch his SNL monologue. Awful.
Oh, bro, my wife will be sick.
But his terrible.
Is hilarious, like though, bro.
He's trash, bro. Get Michael B. Jordan out of here. I'm not watching I Am Legend 2 with Michael, or 3, whatever,
I'm
with Michael
Creed
B.
3, dog.
Bro, Michael Jackson, listen, Michael B. Jordan don't die in Creed 3, bro. That series is for nothing.
If he don't
die.
He
better die. Go out just like his dad. He better go out just like his dad.
That's terrible, bro.
Dennis is stupid.
Hey, bro, this can't be game.
Bro, how you going to end this series with him getting killed in the ring, though? That's awful.
Him, might get him, though.
He
needs
to train his daughter up to carry the series on. He got to go, though.
I
keep taking these beatings.
I think Creed 3 might be dookie because he's actually producing the joint, bro. Like, he's actually directing it.
It's going to be good, though. I feel like it's going to be pretty good, though.
They got me with the story, though.
Yeah,
the
story
all right, we'll
on
see.
Fire.
Michael B. be blowing
but
it
he
for
better,
me,
bro. He better die in the ring. This,
If it's somebody gonna kill him, it's gonna be Joe, dude. But Joe, dude,
yeah, Joe cuz is too strong, bro. I ain't never seen abs like this.
Yo, I ain't never seen abs like this. That's a wild statement, bro. You seen a lot of abs in your life. And like, never
think about it though, but think about it though, bro. Gel cats, the way they be built, be looking too crazy.
Because all they do is
to like the standard gym dude.
That's because they gotta like they gotta lift like tables and stuff. They don't got weights, bro. They on there lifting tables and chairs. They lifting each other.
And they eating the wildest stuff in there too.
They bending over the whole railing like doing sit ups and stuff.
No, I ain't gonna lie, bro.
They gotta use gravity.
12 hours a day working, bro. It's kind of lit in jail, bro.
That's what
you're
saying.
Jail tag, they be on TikTok and stuff going crazy in jail. Like, bro, they be like, having some of the most lit TikToks. And they be having like 2 million followers. The food,
bro.
Like, yo, Bunky, you trying to make some burritos? All right, bet. Let's do it.
Some chicken Alfredo. Say, nah, I quit.
He be cooking it up, bro. Yeah, they got like, how they making little fires and they sell and they're like, bro, how y'all doing this, bro?
Yeah, bro.
Dang.
It's crazy, bro.
This cat said jail is lit now.
Nah,
jail
I'm telling
is lit.
Y'all, man. Sure, they come on, they're like, yo, we got pool table. We got them. Like,
yeah, they be doing the cribs in jail and on TikTok. What's up? This MTV Crib Jail Edition. They come in the plate. They got flat screens. They got Xboxes
this
and stuff.
Play the Xbox, like, you play
bro,
the Xbox in
crazy,
jail?
Bro.
Yeah, nuts, bro.
Y'all cats excited about this Ant-Man?
Yeah, I like Ant-Man. Yeah, I like Ant-Man.
Y'all cats following the Marvel storyline?
Of course.
It's going to be crazy.
This is going to be one of the important ones for this next
This
phase.
Is one of them ones.
Like, they setting everything up with the multiverse, bro. Like, the whole series.
I'm watching the first two with Rachel, right? Because she ain't watching with me. She was calling me a nerd back then, right? So now she's trying to get hip to it, right?
Oh,
back
yeah.
then, they didn't want me.
If you pay attention to it, they kind of was leading up to this, though.
Everything they do is calculated, bro.
Like, if you listen to some of the stuff, like, yo, they talk about alternate reality, all the other stuff, and now they got Kang coming. Y'all thought it got dark with Thanos, though. I'm telling y'all right now.
The only thing I don't like about...
Some of them might die.
Yeah, they already going, bro. Some of the favorites is out of there. Like,
they trying to bring him back, Tony Stark.
Tony Stark ain't coming back, bro.
Alternate universe.
Bro, they set up. They set up. What's her name to take over for him already? The chick that was in Black Panther, bro. Smart chick. Not Shuri. I'm talking about the.
Oh, you talk about the.
The new chick.
Yeah,
she taking over for Iron Man. Yeah, she the next Iron Man.
Oh yeah.
Iron Woman, whatever.
Brave.
But it's all women now, bro. The whole Avengers is women now, bro. Think about it. They done got. I mean, I ain't saying it's a bad thing, but they got Shuri as the Black Panther.
Yeah.
They got Ironheart.
Black Widow was
Black
busy.
She dead though. She ain't coming back.
I mean, but we gotta just.
If she come back, I'm hype. If she come back, I'm hype. Cause she was one of my favorite characters.
It got spooky for them in that one she just did though. Like she's super powerful. She turned evil. So
yeah. Marvel been missing with some of these though, bro.
Thor was dookie. I'm not gonna lie. I know.
I ain't even look at it. I ain't even watch that because it looked trash.
Bro. It's like, listen, if Mout, like all our kids put a movie together, that was Thor Love and Thunder.
They just made a movie like, Daddy, watch this
Super
type
random.
Thing. Yeah.
Now, if you watch it, you're gonna see exactly what I mean.
Nah, I'm not watching that one. I'm not watching it. I could tell by the previews it was gonna be trash.
Yeah, it was terrible. They missed on, and I ain't even gonna lie. All right, so I hope black people don't get mad at me, bro. But Dr. Umar said he called Black Panther 2 Mexican Panther.
That was mad funny.
it was like everything that made the Black Panther strong. He's like, the Mexicans got more if I bring him in the ocean than a park.
This cat gotta chill, bro. He gotta chill. Like, bro, it's a comic series. Like, what are we talking about, bro? Yeah, like, you know Wakanda's not a real place, right? Like, it's not real. It's fictional. Like, how does Wakanda, one of the most powerful nations in the world, lose to an underwater, like, bro,
that's
relax,
laugh,
bro.
I'm like, Wakanda's not ever.
It's not real, bro. Like, he talking about it like he defending it like it's a real place. The Wakandans are the strongest country in the world, and they lost to, like, bro.
He's like, they were whooping Wakandians' butt. I'm like, this cat was good.
Yeah, they're not even Mexicans, though. These cats is Mayans. He calling them Mexicans. That's racist right there. Like,
see, now you picking up where I was, bro. I'm laughing. I'm like, yo, he mad off, bro.
Like, bro, what? I thought that movie was great, though. I don't know. To me, it was great.
Y'all saw it?
Right now.
Yeah, that's the only superhero movie I watched.
Yeah, Dennis don't get into it.
Ant-Man, hey, yo, Ant-Man is a strong buddy that's about to beat Creed up, right?
Yeah, because Kang is
strong buddy.
Wait. Ant-Man is the dude that's fighting Creed?
Kang the Conqueror is the
dude that's about to
beat him. Oh, I thought you were talking about Ant-Man, like the, what's his name, that plays him. I'm like, there's no way, bro. There's no way. Yeah, Paul Rudd. I'm definitely not watching Creed if Paul Rudd is fighting Mike. I never watched that movie.
That's what Mari Hardwick would have had played. If he was doing Creed, he would have had that Paul Rudd play the jail.
He's the most not intimidating person ever, bro. Like,
dang. That's silly.
Yeah, Strong Buddy going crazy out here right now.
Yeah, Strong Kang, Buddy. Kang about to kill a lot of cats, man.
Hey, what's his name? Lit. What's his name, bro?
I don't know. I just...
Actor boy.
Jail cuz.
Yeah, Jill. Strong cuz.
Strong cuz, Jill. Strong
buddy.
What's this cat name, yo?
I don't know, man. I ain't even looking it up, either. I'm just trying to look it up.
Jonathan Majors.
What's his name?
Jonathan Majors.
Hey, Jonathan Majors is a heck of an actor, boy.
Yeah, this cat going from Strong Cuz to Kang the Conqueror. This cat going wild right now.
Where is he at, though?
Wild range of stuff he's doing, he going to.
He on Creed.
Oh, I see him. Yeah. Oh, wait, that's the dude. Yeah, that's the homie from The Harder We Fall.
Yeah,
he's dope. He's really dope.
Yeah, he's a great actor.
He's dope. I hope he beats Michael B. Jordan down, bro.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Ain't no way he can get in the ring with this storyline not down.
Y'all seen the harder we fall?
Yeah, all right. It was good.
Bro, he was the coolest actor I've ever seen in that movie, bro. He was just too cool. I'm like, yeah, I like this dude.
Hey, what's his mannerism.
He a way better actor too.
Friends or The Office?
What? Friends of The Office.
Yeah, what's
The Office? I don't really watch Friends like that.
Okay.
I don't watch The Office.
I've been watching Abbott Elementary is back.
That's silly.
I ain't been watching that either. I heard it's funny, a good show. I need to watch that.
Yeah, she be having.
Yo, home. The girl you say you know, she on there heavy in this season, bro.
Oh, is she?
Yeah, I think it's her. She plays like one of the moms. Don't she play the mom of the one dude?
Oh, the one kid.
I thought she was a teacher in the joint.
Nah, she's not a teacher.
Nate Jones?
Yeah, she plays the mom of the one kid. Yeah, that show is good, bro.
The silliest is the principal on there. She be having me dying, bro.
Yeah.
She like, I own a school. Like, you're a principal. You don't own a school.
Nah, I like the janitor dude, bro. His one-liners be mad funny, bro. Yeah. The old janitor cat. Yeah. Nah, that's a good... Yeah, that show is funny.
Hey, speaking of her, and this is random because she was in it, but Snowfall coming back, too.
Yes, sir.
Snowfall coming.
They got to make up for last season because last season was kind of boo boo.
Yeah, man.
Boo boo.
Yeah, cuz tripping on the drugs for a whole
him, her, bodies.
I'm like, man, yo, tighten up, man. This cat hiding from tigers and stuff. Lion, tigers, and bears.
Oh, my.
Yeah, that was not wild.
I'm like, bro, this cat just. This is Franklin Saint, bro. Right, why is he under somebody's house? Hiding, like, what is going on?
I gotta catch up on
like,
Snowfall. I ain't even get
there. Yeah, man, check it out, bro. Oh, dang, the last season was kind of weak, but they saying it should end out with a bang, bro. This is the last season, so we'll see what happens, man. Stuff wasn't the same when John Singleton passed.
Right.
Yeah.
You can tell the difference.
Yeah, you can tell. What else, man? Anything else coming up?
Man.
I ain't got none.
It's a spy balloon. It's a spy balloon from China that they just shot down. You know, I hear about the spy balloon.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. China sent a balloon over here to spy on us, and Biden just shot it down. That's the biggest news I've seen.
I did hear something that they expect the whole world to be at war with China by 2025.
The whole world?
Yeah, it's gonna be China versus everybody by 2025.
I think, bro, that's scary, but I could see Russia teaming up with them. If it's China and Russia versus everybody, that's scary. That's scary too.
And Russia just got back nuclear, cuz, so it's about to be low for everybody.
They got back
arms dealer,
he back. Arms
cuz is back, bro.
Yo, look at the arms.
Back like you never left, though. Technology on a million.
They brought the goat back. They brought the goat. The goat nuke. The goat
nuke. Bro, that's so crazy that that's the conversation. Like, bro, we traded a WNBA player.
Well, they said that he had a couple more months. But still, though, hold him as long as you can, dog. Bro,
they said that was the biggest trade in WNBA history or something like that.
Yo, that's crazy, man.
That's hilarious.
What they say, they traded a big for... Nah, man. Nah,
a big for a shooter?
Stop laughing, bro. That was too silly to me, man. That was too silly.
Yo, that's big so for good. A shooter.
I was like, dang. We really did just trade a shooter.
That's crazy, bro.
Yo, Russia and China, man. Listen, I don't want no smoke with y'all, man. Just let no me keep smoke, living my bro. Life, man. You know what I'm
that's
saying?
Why I'm out here in the mountains. They ain't gonna find
why me, they man. Gotta disturb the peace of everybody, though? Like, all these other countries are, like, cool with each other, and these cats just be like, no. Man, no. Like, we ain't with that. We ain't with that kumbaya stuff. Like, we about, like, man, why can't y'all just be cool? Like,
cats is on
a lot
go,
of people say
bro.
It's us, bro. They say we be trying to bully cats.
Bruh.
Just leave cats
we
alone.
Ain't even, we ain't even in it. Like,
I'm not a world, I don't know enough about world politics, but just everybody just leave each other alone.
Yeah, just chill. Like, why is that so hard, bro? Like, why we got to beef with each other? Like, haven't we grown past that? Like, don't you think, like, think about it, bro. I just had this thought, bro.
We'll be talking about towards the end.
Because think about it, bro. As men, right? As adults, as people, right?
Right.
Like, you guys, when you younger, you be beefing with people. You got little conflicts here and there. But, like, the older we get, we just like, man, I'm cool. Like, let's just be cool with people. If we got our differences, like, I'm going to just stay away.
I'm not trying to fight nobody.
But why wouldn't... Why ain't the world like that, though? Like, all right, we've been around long enough, bro. The world been here long enough. Like, let's put our differences aside.
The world and mad just, old,
bro. Yeah, bro, like, we mad old, man. Old. We gotta mature, like.
That's their words, though, bro.
Like, put our differences aside, bro. Y'all don't want to fight. Let's be honest. Nobody wants to fight, bro. Right. Like, let's just...
Bro,
we got more similarities than we got differences if we realize it. Like, if we really sit down and think, like, it's more similarities than differences.
Everybody just want money and land, and it ain't no new land that's popping up.
Yo, just
and the more money you print, the less
like, just leave each other alone, man. Like, just do good business and take a nap. Hey, just take a nap. Oh, y'all, just go to sleep. When you
sometimes
feel like you
that's
to...
all you need, bro. You wake up a new person after a good nap, bro.
Kanye West changed my life with that, bro.
Energy, like, said, energy, said, way different.
Yeah, I seen something silly, bro. They was talking about like how the world is like $10 trillion in debt, and they're like, bro, who do we owe though? Like, who is the world in debt?
Right, like, bro, we owe ourselves, bro.
Like, who do we owe? Like, Mars? Like, what are we talking about, bro?
Bro,
like,
and being that you can print money, bro, you should never ever be in debt.
Like, right. Yo, how much we owe y'all? All right, like, let me go print 10 billies real quick.
It's crazy. 10 billion. It'll probably take 2 years to print $10 billion.
That's why I said like 10 trillion or something.
Yeah,
like
10
that.
Trillion in debt is crazy, bro. We're never gonna pay that back
as a world.
America's
bro.
Gonna be America's gonna be in debt for the rest of humanity.
Yeah. I see why America ain't trying to get rid of these student loans, man. They in too much debt. They counting on that money to come back.
Bro, I think Biden just like, I swear Biden is just bro, telling people what they want to hear. He just telling people what they want to hear, bro, just to get people hyped up for him.
Has anybody seen the reduction?
No, it didn't happen because they sent another email. They sent another a follow-up email saying like, oh, actually... Disregard the first email. We made a mistake. Like, bro, this is coming from the like, this is coming from the federal like board of education. How do y'all make a mistake on an email? Like,
to millions of people, though. Like, we made.
I'm telling you what happened, bro. People started dogging Biden. People like, yo, this cat Biden. They saying what we say. Yo, Biden is trash. But if he gets rid of our student debts, he's back up. Biden said, yo, just send the email out. Just send it. Like, make them think they're getting it. Like, get them back
yo,
on my side.
Too soon, bro. He should have drugged that out a little bit longer.
He making this Trump campaign easy as hell.
Yeah, he making it
Trump about to come
easy.
Back. Let me tell you something. Y'all miss me, right? You see what happened.
Bro, if Trump comes back, that's the first time that's ever happened, right? Can that happen?
Yeah. That's yeah.
Like a cat. Be a president and then get beat and then come back the following term and run again. Like you
bro,
can do that.
He was
the Cavs did it.
You said the Cavs did it.
Yo, y'all hear what's going on with Hunter Biden, bro?
Oh, he wildin', bro. That boy, he wild.
I ain't gonna make it crazy, right? But if this was Trump's kids, it would be all over the news, right?
Yeah.
What is he doing? I forgot.
This cat, he okay, so he sold a laptop with, like, allegedly to a pawn shop with, like, documents on it. He had a video of him weighing crack.
Oh, he coked out. Smoking. It's the president's son coked out.
In the White House, though?
But then he also tried to sue a prostitute because he don't want their baby to have his last name.
I heard that. That's the one I heard. Yeah. Yeah, he a sick dude, bro.
Now, just like, if this is Trump's third cousin that's going to be on the news. This is Joe Biden's son.
Trump, this is his family. Look what he's doing. Like, man. Yeah, that is wild, bro. Hunter Biden's a wild boy, bro. If your dad would be the president and you out here moving like that during his term.
He was like, I can eyeball that. That looks like a grand. Like, he's saying it on video, bro.
He said that?
Bro, he's wild on these videos, bro. Yo, why are you recording yourself with. Never mind.
Yeah, bro. People are dumb, bro. People are dumb, and there's something else I got to say. Bro, there's some real weirdos on Facebook and Instagram, bro. Like, if you on Instagram and Facebook posting with your shirt off, thirst trapping, like, you a weirdo, man.
Wait, a dude doing this, bro?
Yeah, man. Like, I just be seeing weird stuff, and I'm like, yo, like, what is wrong with people, bro? Yo. Like, you a real life weirdo. Like, y'all gotta chill.
Dang, man.
That's all I got, man. But yo,
Shout out to Nick for making it this late, man. Nick, I hope
Nick, if you made it, bro. This is the thing, bro. If y'all make it this late, y'all getting the exclusive content.
Right. And it's like, late, y'all gotta like stick around. Recording. It's
and y'all long. Can't fast forward it, bro. Don't fast forward through the pod to the end. Listen to that joint, bro.
Y'all know we get crazy and late. Like,
we
late
start getting part. Silly at the end. Yeah, especially late night joints. If it's past 8, you know it's some
and
silly
y'all lucky
stuff
my boys ain't sipping no wine. If they were sipping wine, yeah,
not today.
Been crazy.
Not the wine today, man.
Not today.
We had the wine, I'd be sweating.
I'd be asleep if we had the wine. I just get tired. I get mad tired when I drink.
Don't ever sweat it on the episode. You know what time it is.
Carlin, imagine that, bro. This cat Kalo fall asleep on the pod.
Wake up, bro. I'm sleeping and Dennis sweating. Like.
Yo, that'd be crazy.
Oh, man.
Yeah,
oh,
man.
All right.
Yeah, we ain't drinking champs. We ain't drinking champs.
Yeah, man. Not yet. It's like, nah. Drink Champs is different. I'm not doing what they do on a pod, but that'll be the worst pod ever. Like, these cats.
You pass a Hibiki? Pass a Hibiki? Right. All this
cat. Bro, they be. These cats be lit. Hey,
fellas, they be, like, really fellas. Pressuring.
Uh-oh.
Bad news, fellas.
No.
This
no.
Just
no.
Don't tell me.
Clippers are the latest team they engaged in trade talks for net star Kyrie Irving.
That's okay.
Lakers, Mavericks, and Suns.
That's okay. They could engage in it. That's cool. I ain't mad at that.
If Kyrie
Irving comes to LA and goes to the Clippers,
yeah, you dead to
bro,
me, Kyrie.
You
dead.
Kyrie, you don't deserve to see no more chips in here.
You ain't ever mention his name again.
You ain't even try Kyrie at that point.
Yo, I'm taking away your ring that you won with Bron if you go to the Clippers, bro. It don't count in my record book, bro.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah, bro, because L.A. is clearly the best
team. You don't deserve
team.
My respect, bro. Yeah.
The Lakers is clearly the best team in L.A. again.
You a clown, bro. And for that reason, I'm out. Y'all watch Shark Tank? Yeah. Shark Tank is my show. And for that reason, I'm out. Yeah. Mark Cuban be dogging these cats, bro.
He be like, I'll give you... Temperature for me, but I need you to answer right now. Like, these cats gave these whole big old.
Yeah,
like,
bruh. I've been binging Shark Tank because I don't got nothing else to do, and that's my show, bruh.
Actually, I've been watching Better Call Saul. I ain't no Better Call Saul. It was just good.
Bro. I heard it was lit, bruh, but for whatever reason, I couldn't get into it.
I couldn't get into it.
And I love Breaking Bad, though. I love Breaking Bad.
Super slow. Six episode, and you can see it starting to pick up.
Is it off the storyline of Breaking Bad? Like,
it's all good, man. Like, you get the
I know that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, his story beforehand. The old white dude. I don't know his name, but he on the first episode, the first season.
Walter White, dude.
Other dude, the bald dude. You know.
The cop.
Yeah, the cop.
Hank.
Hey, after watching on, Hank. Hunter,
I think he is an older cat. He was working with a.
Oh, I know you're talking about the dude.
The old dude.
Yeah, the old man. Yeah.
He talking,
see him. Oh, snaps, he right here.
Yo, brother, Walter White in Your Honor is crazy, bro.
Yeah, he going crazy. I'm he's like, a great actor.
They got the Walter White doing the wildest and the unthinkable. He doing the unthinkable roles.
Y'all like. Cats about to make me get to it, man. I ain't get to it yet.
Oh, Your Honor is great, bro. Your Honor is great. Watch the first season.
I watched the first season. I ain't get to the second season.
Oh, okay, yeah, nah. First episode is good. Second, yeah, I watched first two. They both good.
Yeah, I watched. I'm caught up on it now. It's pretty good, bro.
Yeah, man, but shoot, man, listen, we 2-in.
My
kids out here making noise and stuff, man.
I heard my kids.
Yeah, I need to go check my youngin' out too, man. So, you know, but check us out.
Let them know real quick, man. Let them know real quick, bro.
Honest to God. Honest to number 2 God Pod, man. We here, episode 87, man.
The Gronkowski.
Catch us on Google Pod.
Google Pod.
Apple Pod.
Apple Pod.
Spotify.
Spotify.
Instagram. TikTok. Twitter.
Swag.
Facebook.
We here, baby.
Yeah, episode 87, man. Caleb gonna close us out whenever he get a chance.
Right.
But, you know what I'm saying? Right.
Check on y'all strong friends, man.
You know, you got to.
Check on your strong friends.
If you looking up to buy a house.
Especially if your strong friends contemplating buying these Beyonce tickets. Check on them, man.
Yeah, bro.
What's up, Lord?
Tell him not to do that.
Yeah, send them my way if they try to buy Beyonce tickets.
He looking like Jace.
I was just about to say he looks
bad.
You think so?
Yeah, he's starting to look like Jace a little bit.
Yeah, when I look at them both in the face.
I thought
yeah, in the face, yeah.
Yeah,
you see that?
Yeah, I was on Twitter, bro, and this girl, like, she had the same kids by the same dad. He was like, your kids really look alike. She was like, that's what happened when you had the same baby daddy. She's like, they go look alike.
Right,
like,
that's supposed to be common, right?
I was cracking up, man.
Yeah, man.
People be surprised when you do stuff the way you're supposed to. You got 2 kids with the same woman? Yeah, wait, that's your wife? You married to her? Like, yes. Like,
yeah, he look just like
hey, bro, boy. Kid. Hey, how do kids laugh like that and just go straight face?
Right. Bruh.
That's how one son be, right? He be cracking up and they just
look like.
Then I'm laughing is funny, bro. He be dying,
yeah,
bro.
He be cracking up.
I'm like, this cat gonna be silly. All right, man. Let me play the outro, yeah, man. I don't know what time it is.
Honest to God, baby.
Honest to God.
Yeah. Hey.
Come on, man. Stop rapping.
Call with her early. He didn't even let her fill it up.
Hey. Look at Kyle throwing it up, too. Hey, Kyle did the same thing.